mind if I do?
Covino and Rich. Honestly, how do I deal with you every day? So ridiculous.
What?
You're such a fool.
Get out of here.
Oh, I'm a disc jockey.
What's a disc jockey?
Turn it up. We're doing a show.
Here we go.
Covino and Rich.
Let's go.
Wow!
All right. Happy that we are all together today.
No, you're not.
He hasn't spoken one word to us the entire morning until the mics went on.
Hey, everybody.
Big phony right here.
What's going on?
Hey, what's going on? Guy Smiley here.
This guy was cursing everybody out before the show started.
You get your shit in line.
Didn't
Fuck
even look
you.
Me in the eye one time. The mics go on. The lights are on. He's Mr. Nice Guy. Don't be fooled. The Velvet Wolf, Rich Davis.
You feel like we've ever met someone like that?
Try to think if we've ever worked with someone that was like nice, but like sort of an asshole once the mics were off.
No, but we've heard the stories. We're Covino and Rich. What's up, everybody? Let's be rocking out.
Little beefy.
Yes, come here.
Let us get a grito. It's too early for gritos. What's up, Fabian McIntosh, Terry Hickey, Lisa's and Kim's and Rolando's? Everybody hitting us up on YouTube live chat.
You know who I wanted to say hi to?
Who?
Bree McCutcheon.
Hi, Bree McCutcheon.
Anthony Aguirre. Aguirre.
How do you know it's not Anthony Aguirre?
That's Aguirre.
Aguirre.
Anthony Aguirre and Bree, two listeners, got married.
Look at us.
Married? Look at that. So,
changing
hey.
Relationships, changing lives.
Bree and Anthony, congratulations. I saw that they tied the knot.
Congratulations, guys. Congratulations, everybody watching the show today, hanging out with us. Millions of other people hanging out with us today. Right, Spot? Today's a freebie. Today's a free show. Spotty's here. Rich Davis, the Angry Velvet Wolf. Steve Covino welcoming you to our Patreon.
I showed you
I feel like I got like a random hair like hitting me on the neck. Yeah, you feel them on your ears. Anyway, thank you for being here. I appreciate it. Getting ready for a kick-ass September. A September to remember.
Yeah.
August like that. Where does the time go?
We were just talking about
where
that
does it go?
Off the air.
August is over. My birthday month is done.
I showed you a meme moments ago, and I think we both interpreted it the right way, right?
Yeah.
Spot, I sent you a meme, and it's the Fonz and Paris Hilton.
Well, I didn't get it at first. It took me a second.
Is it a brain buster, dumb meme, or are we not getting it, is my question.
Which is the way to look at this meme?
Yeah, I saw a meme and I go, Covino.
Starting off with a riddle today.
My first thought was, it's a picture of Paris Hilton and the Fonz. And under Paris, it says Thursday. Under the Fonz, it says Friday. Spot, tell me how you interpret this and I'll see if we're on the same page.
I assume Thursday is, that's hot.
Yeah, because Thursday on the little thing, it's 96 degrees.
That's hot.
That's hot. And then Friday is 76 degrees and it's a picture of the Fonz. Cool. Like, is that...
It's funny though. It's
cool
is the fun.
Haze? Is it gonna be cool on Friday?
Cool. Well, 76. It's cool.
Cool. So it's going from hot to cool.
Ooh, cool.
All right. I feel like Spot's under the weather. Are you under the weather? Speaking of the weather,
incredibly under the weather.
Oh, okay. So there's Paris Hilton. There's the Fonz.
Here's Spots
underneath.
Under, Spots there.
He's under there, being like this, because he's under the weather.
Cool.
I was singing Thursday, Friday, happy days.
There's Spot. Under the weather. The weather.
All right. Well, orale. Thank you guys for hanging out.
I'm under the weather. Look at those eyes. Jeez.
Steve Suolvino, Covino. Thank you. Mr. McIntosh, hi, Jen. And let's get into it. Let's let the good times roll way back on a Wednesday. Yeah, where does the time go? Something I've been harping on a lot.
Oh,
a lot.
You think?
Yeah.
I just showed you a picture of me in college, like a little nerd with a red Solo cup. And you're like, bro, where does the time go? That's like a 20-year-old picture. And I'm like, yeah, I guess you're right. It's just,
I'll be posting a teenage dirtbag video later. Rich posted one yesterday. So that got me in the mindset of looking through old photos and trying to find old photos. We established yesterday that photos of you, of our generation, mm-hmm. when it comes to your teenage years, they're hard to find for obvious reason. But it's almost as if you didn't exist from 13 to 19. Like, you didn't exist. Those pictures are hard to find.
Very hard to find.
But in my mission to try to find these photos to be part of the viral craze, teenage dirtbag, it puts you in that mindset of like, yeah,
time is fleeting. What's going on?
Yeah, but yeah, I remember. Yeah. Uh-huh. Nah. And I'll tell you why. You know what's even more weird about it for me personally? Because I feel like there's still parts of my life where I'm starting over fresh, but I know I'm older. You know what I mean? Like, career-wise, I feel like we're starting over again. So yeah. I feel like, oh, like that 20-something-year-old.
The first day of school.
Yeah. That 20-something-year-old still on his come up, because I'm still hungry because we're still on our way up and new opportunities are still ahead. And I'm in a relatively newer relationship, right? And if that goes forward, hey, more kids maybe in the future. Like, life is still still there for me.
An announcement.
How's that like an announcement? That's not an announcement. That's like ongoing for the past like 5 years. So it's just when the time is right, right? And when the trigger's pulled. But, you know, I still feel like all those things are ahead of me. Meanwhile, like, I've lived so much life. So it's like, yeah, I still got all these, like, new sort of life things to live. I'm like, yeah, but I already lived so much life.
Yeah.
Gosh.
Well, the teenage dirtbag, the teenage dirtbag video rage, I know, got you thinking, but
It really makes me upset a little bit. It puts me in a bad mood.
You know what makes me upset? How, and I love that you did admit this to me, that your daughter said the same thing.
Yeah.
Your OCD catechdotistics get in your way. They really do. I think you might say, no, bro, that's who I am. But something happened.
Ridiculous about being meticulous.
Where
I care about detail.
If your daughter and I said the same exact thing.
I pay attention to detail. Just because everybody else doesn't mean I need to stoop to those weak ass levels. That's how I am, man.
If I tell people the weak ass levels, they're going
to
say.
My daughter and I figured it'd be a great bonding opportunity. I'm like, Melody, teach me how to do this shit. You do this in your sleep.
Yeah.
Show me how to edit these TikTok videos. Dad wants to do this. I'm all depressed now. Help me. And she did, but I didn't crop the photos. So every photo in the video is like this big, that big, that big, that big, that big, that big. And that shit bothers me.
But I said, Covino, you think people will watch it? They'll be like, oh, cool, old pictures of Covino. And then on to the very next video.
I don't care what you think and he thinks. I care about what I think.
But spending like a day or so.
I agree with Covino.
Is that why you didn't send anything yesterday?
No, I didn't send anything yesterday because I was laid out in bed.
Dying.
Oh.
Spot's on. Remember the weather's here?
Oh, he's there.
Spot's there.
Gotcha.
Not to mention, can I tell you? I had to silence my phone yesterday. I actually went in to our group chat and turned off notifications because the two of you were having some sort of conversation. I woke up, there were like, no joke, 150 notifications from our group chat.
Oh, Spot, Rich and I were going back and forth about student debt, the student loan.
I'm like, what the fuck is going on? So I didn't even notice it.
Yeah, but
I was laid out all day.
He got to the level where we're muted on the text.
Yeah.
I mean
he didn't even chime in once.
It was ridiculous. Yeah, you're
right. It should have been a clandestine.
He
doesn't want clandestine conversations.
But he didn't even participate, so it should have been between you and I.
I was out of it. I was trying to keep up. I'm like, what is going on here? And I couldn't figure it out.
Well,
Rich and I are going back and forth.
Let them have their anger. You know why? Because that situation doesn't anger me, so I let it go. That being said, I agree with Covino because you want it to be like properly framed.
Yeah, and one of them, I took a picture of it, and you see I took a picture of the picture, and it's on the carpet. Like I scanned it, and you see the carpet in the background. I'm like, I didn't crop it, so I went to Melody.
I will see.
Let's do this over again because Dad didn't crop the photos, and she's like, Dad, I'm not feeding into your OCD. I'm like, all right, well, ask your dad to help you with some shit again.
And then I said the same thing to him this morning, and it made me realize.
Well, because you guys
on social media,
like sloppy work, man.
On social media,
like Rich, your video was great. Your video was fantastic.
Yeah, it was
all
really
the
good.
Photos were cropped properly. I will say one thing.
But
say one thing. You missed the drop a little bit.
Oh, see.
What do you mean I missed the drop?
You hit the beat.
Did you hit the beat on yours?
Okay. Don't be a dick.
Anyway,
you didn't do it.
You fucking got me sick. So don't be a dick.
Oh,
people got me sick.
Get you sick.
This house got me sick.
No one's sick in this house.
This house gets everybody.
Your
sick.
Friends that came to visit were sick and got me sick.
All right, I'll text Nico now that you're blaming him. I am. Well, he'll hear it. He listens to our show.
Tell him his wife and his son got me sick.
Rich is always schmoozing.
The whores weren't sick. I didn't get sick from the whores.
Yeah, I'm sure there's no chance that it was the whore party you went to.
Not everybody heard about the whore party,
bro. Rude when you say things like that. You're very rude.
You said I got you sick when no one in this house is
before
sick.
Before that, you were like, well, yours wasn't. What about yours? You're very rude.
Because you're a critic.
Hi, everyone. I was just telling you. I'm commending Covino for having...
Yeah, but I think no product.
What is it? Meticulous. What is it?
Ridiculous. About being ridiculous. I mean, it was just cropping of the photos, and it was like a small fail that, you know, pride in your work.
I don't know. I just think that pride in your work is different than pride in a video that people will watch for 10 seconds and move on to the next. I think it's just more important to get it out there.
I do these so few and far between. If I'm going to do them, I'm going to do them right. And that's how I felt about it. But, you know, I'm looking through these photos and they really put me in a really bad mindset after a while. I realized, why am I grumpy? Oh, yeah, because I realized, like, getting old and that sucks. But, like I've always said and I keep saying, there's honor in the fight.
We're all getting old.
Fuck that, bro. I'm like Andy Ruiz, not gordito. Just I'm in the fight this weekend.
You're like Andy Ruiz because you like tacos, you like boxing, and you're Mexican. And if you didn't watch what you ate, you would be Andy Ruiz, perhaps.
He fights this weekend. That's why I brought him up. He fights Luis Ortiz.
I don't think anyone cares about Andy Ruiz anymore. I think he's one of those guys where
if he wins, they're going to be caring about him. The guy he's fighting this weekend is a beast. But anyway,
he had his moment. He had his Buster Douglas moment,
or did he?
And I'm not saying he's not a decent fighter that you'll see here and there. But Andy Ruiz, count him out of the category of the Deontay Wilders and Tyson Furies, and he beat Anthony Joshua and shocked the world. It was amazing.
But I mean,
I don't think he's on that level. He's not in the Usyk level. He's not in any of those guys' level.
Based on what? We'll see.
Do me a favor. Can you go like this?
Who?
You, Covino.
Why?
Just do it.
Oh, you're going to put me on Andy Ruiz's body? Well, look at that.
Same guy.
Anyway, I'm not here to talk about sports. Yeah. I'm here to talk about how miserable I was looking through all these old pictures, trying to figure out where did the time go? Not only that, it's like, where did that, like if I'm holding up a picture, like where did that go? Like if I'm holding up a present or a shirt or like, you know, all these things, where did it go?
It's a really good question.
Gone.
Well, you know what the good-
It's so sad. Those moments are gone.
Lingers more on a guy.
Bothers me.
That type of question lingers more in the mind of a guy like you who does know where all your possessions are. Because I do think that when I look at pictures of myself, but I just assume, well, I must have just did the go through the t-shirts and it didn't make the cut. But you're right. There is a time where every old shirt, pair of pants, everything you had, at one point you were like, it's time to say goodbye. Because I make sure there's a couple. You know, if you have shirts or anything that's valuable to you, you'll make sure never to lose it in the cut.
Exactly. You know who makes me feel guilty about this the most? Like my mom brings up stuff like that. Steven, whatever happened to that? Like, I don't know, Mom. Don't you care? I'm like, I mean, yeah, if I dwell on it.
Yeah, you dumbass.
By the way, Mauser said,
like, I don't know, Mom,
based on your mood.
I moved in like six times, I got rid of stuff.
Based on your mood, Mauser's right. Maybe you should do, instead of Teenage Dirtbag, Hurt by Johnny Cash and just about like a sad montage of
middle-aged sad guy. Anyway, thank you.
It's actually a good idea. That would change her from like a lighthearted challenge to like the saddest challenge. The
only I mean, I'll tell you what. That's real. I really had this is well, I changed this song to Squirt to make it happier.
Oh,
the old familiar.
I had a bellyache yesterday. This is true. I've been gassy like Freddie Blassie. I've been really like, my belly's been hurting me, right? But the truth is, I think looking through all these photos, trying to find them for these videos, and Rich was going to make one, so I'm sending them to Rich too, and we'll post one later, I think put me in a mindset and made me sort of like mad and miserable. I'm serious. So I'm like, man, subconsciously, I'm like, man. Hey, Spot, I'm going to send you this picture. And it really depicts like... That was recent. All away.
Oh, he's just doing a
slideshow.
Slideshow of middle-aged Covino. Everything.
Shot what have I become? Yeah. And by the way, I'm hanging in there. I can't imagine how you fucking old man Rivers feel. It's not fair. Well, that's not fair. Goes away in the end. Is this gonna make you cry? Rock on! Here, pull up that picture. I'll give you an example of what happens. Ready? I sent Spot a picture, and here's like what happens in my life all the time. Looking through these pictures, I have to go through a Rubbermaid bin. I open up all these fucking shoe boxes. I find this one, and then I'll like send it to my mom. Or sometimes my mom sends me pictures like this, and then she'll be like, "Steven, look how skinny you were." Or she'll be like, "Look how young you are."
Thanks, Mom.
And like immediately I'm like, but my mom is also the first to praise me and tell me how handsome I am. That's the truth. But she will say things like that, and she'll say, "What happened to that picture? You used to love it. Remember when we bought it for you?" And I would be like, "Yeah." And then I'm forced to be like, "What did happen to that picture? I know I probably sold it as part of the Yankee bundle, Mom. I don't know.
Who has time? Someone owns that right
Someone
now.
Owns it." And then I'll like dwell on, "Yeah, I wonder where that thing is right now." And I'm like, "What is that, a Wake Forest hat I'm wearing? What happened to that? I donate it? I don't know."
Hey, where is Wake Forest?
Where is Wake Forest? Man.
You had the hat.
Somewhere in the woods?
It's like asking me, name a Pink Floyd song when I wear a Pink Floyd shirt.
College kid. I don't even play by those rules anymore. I used to wear Kentucky hats, I would wear South Carolina hats all the time. Know why?
Why?
Steve Covino. SC. You know what I mean? Yeah. I wore them all. I would never do that. Wake Forest. I feel like you've asked me this before.
We used to play Wake Forest. Apparently.
Let's see. Where is Wake Forest?
Think. Right? Maybe. I don't know.
If I got it, I'd just be guessing right now. Is it in the Carolinas? Is that right? Okay, yeah. Salem, North Carolina.
North, I believe, yeah.
I think that's a Boilermaker hat. I'm not even sure. Or is that a... Yeah, I think so. But anyway, like, you're going through all these photos. It puts you in a mindset. And all day I felt off. All day.
What a plaque. Yankee Stadium.
Yeah.
Steven, you were so young, and what happened to that plaque?
I don't know, Mom. I got rid of it. What about all the cards?
I don't know, Mom.
But that, you used to love that plaque.
I know. Jesus, stop it.
The guilt trips are real. I don't think that's the intention. I think my mom's genuinely like, "Why did you do that?" And I'm like, "I don't know. I had no room for it, Mom." Mm-hmm. No room for it. Anyway, life goes on, and it goes fast. What does Ferris Bueller say? Spot.
Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
There it is. The end. Moving on. Way back on a Wednesday.
Steven, where's your Big Johnson shirt from 94?
Don't you miss it?
Your hypercolor shirt. What about your freezy freakies?
I think that's also my mom's way of saying she remembers, but it makes you feel like shit. And it makes you feel like, man, time's a flying. It really is. So much so that I don't even know the answers to these questions. I don't know what happened to it. But, like, I've already, like, we've lived long enough to, like, have had it, have gotten rid of it, and, like, almost forgotten about it. That's how much time has gone by now.
Oh, yeah.
So, for me now, to make this a full circle conversation, to me, to have lived that much life, right?
Yeah.
And to still be starting over in so many ways.
Yeah.
Is so fucking weird to me. You see
awesome.
What I'm
you should look at it as
there's two ways to look at it. You yeah, like say, wow, man, I still
how
got,
awesome is this?
Yeah, like man, I get it's the rebirth of slick.
Yeah, you're
but I'm like I don't know.
You're in your 40s.
I still feel
and,
like man, I'm like old or some
listen,
shit.
Man,
I'm like
not,
old, but I'm not.
You're not old.
I'm
you're
like in purgatory of aging.
You're in your 40s.
Like in the middle somewhere.
Career, personal life, and everything has revamped for you, and is in the middle of revamping. I think it's a good thing. I think
no the
come on
the reality is not matching the reality. Like, I'm an older guy.
The reality is not matching the reality.
Because I'm an older guy. Really, in reality.
Okay.
I'm like getting up there, right? But I'm doing all these things still that a guy who's just starting off is doing. So I'm established, but I'm still establishing myself.
So career moves, relationship moves, possibly babies, possibly marriage.
But I'm saying all these things.
Lots of life ahead of me.
You're saying all these things that people like, doing
do
their.
Do I have the energy for that?
All these things people
sip
have.
On my coffee.
All these things people traditionally do, you're saying like, old school days, like in their 20s, here you are doing it in your 40s.
Yes.
Like, we have friends talking about retirement. I'm thinking about, like, new opportunities.
Yeah. Hey, everyone.
Like I said, do I have the energy?
Everyone has a different level of relevance and energy and success. And, hey, listen, man.
I look at it this way. You know why I lounge around and I'm lazy so much? Because I'm conserving my energy for all of this. That's how I justify it. Like, I don't know if I have the energy. No. I'm resting now because I'm going to need that energy. That's how I, yeah.
Andrew Hart said, I lost an LA King snapback hat in my brother's bachelor party. I still wonder what happened to that
hat.
Andrew,
don't you miss it? Don't you miss it?
Listen, I'm being serious.
Does it bother you?
There are things.
It bothers me.
There are things that you wonder where they are. Now,
that happens all the time.
I mean, we've talked about this, so we don't need to harp on it.
It's always late at night where you're like, where's my birth certificate? I don't know.
Well, I lost that on you.
No, but that's a typical example of people.
But
thinking about I don't know where it is.
I'm convinced, though, that what percentage of it is in someone else's possession versus in a fucking dumpster somewhere?
Some third world person rocking my old stuff.
Like if you said, man, you know, I left a watch I loved at a hotel 5 years ago. Did someone else pick up that watch and now in like Cincinnati, there's some dude that still has your watch?
Wouldn't you like to know the life of that watch?
Did that watch just make it into a trash can and you never had a shot at getting it again anyway?
Some shit I just didn't have the room for.
A car you had along the way. Let's say in the 2000s, you had a 2002 Toyota Camry.
It's the Papa John story.
Yeah, no, but I'm saying like you could probably search it down, but do you think that car still exists? Or you think, no, fucking in a junkyard somewhere. It's been long gone.
Long gone. My first 93 Sentra, long gone. I sold it to a Puerto Rican guy that used to call me Killa. True story. Nah, 93 Sentra, it was...
I've seen old cars. I've seen old Sentras.
Nah, that thing's long gone.
Well, one of my little carry-on suitcases I used for years, because it was just convenient. And until I got my... this is not a commercial. It was maybe 6 months ago. We got those knack bags. Fucking best bag I ever got.
It's a good bag.
Got the knack bag, that's the best carry-on I have now. But I used to use a bag, and I'm like, Sarah, I love this bag. What is it? She goes, oh, it was like one of her exes, and he left it at her place. And I loved it. I used it all the time. And I'm like, I wonder if her ex would ever even believe, like, you know that little duffel bag? My ex's husband uses it on business trips. So you're right. You don't know where your old school shit goes. There's no way on earth that guy probably thinks, oh, that little rolly duffel bag thing I have? Yeah, I left it at my ex Sarah's house, and now her husband uses it 15 years later.
I mean,
it happens.
I mean, there's another way to look at this, too. It's like you've been blessed, and you're very fortunate to have had lots of cool things. You know, you just can't hold on to everything forever. But like Rich said, you hold on to the things that meant the most. And
but you know,
I think I've done a pretty good job.
I like your sentiment, though, that you have really big things brewing in your work life and your personal life.
Yeah.
And you're in your mind at a stage of, whoa, most people don't have new things cooking career and personal at 40-something.
Yeah. And like my life doesn't match up.
Most people at 40-something are...
It's a mental gymnastics sort of justification.
Most people at 40-something have some sense of...
I'm like, I have gray in my beard. I got gray in my beard. I should, like, this not, it doesn't add up.
Yeah.
You know? It's not adding up. Anyway, thank you guys for hearing me out. Yesterday was an emotional day.
Do you know where this hat is?
You know, I wonder.
Steven, you love that 3-year-old birthday hat. I remember I made you the count hat cake.
You know what's so funny? It's so funny that this, it all ties together, Spot, because I was traumatized. I swear to you, by losing that shirt that I'm wearing right there. Traumatized.
Is that a, what is that?
It's a Bronx Lion? Zoo shirt.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. I remember you talking about that.
And I talked about this on the show. I was a little kid. I'm 3 years old there, right? I probably rocked that shit till I was 5. Okay. My parents took me to the beach and I loved that shirt. I'm a Leo. There was a lion on it.
Yeah.
I had fun at the Bronx Zoo, had little pins, had the t-shirt to prove it. It's all happening at the zoo.
At the zoo.
Yo, Mr. Tiger.
True story.
Mr. Lion. Parents take me to Lavalette or Seaside Heights or whatever. And my dad was wearing his cutoff jean shorts. And we're in the car on the way back. And I'm like, forgot my shirt.
Ah! Ew, that's too bad.
I'm not turning around.
I'm like, no.
And you can see how that blends in with the sand.
You never gonna find it.
too bad. And I was like, no.
And dude, that has made you the maniac you are today.
Always wondered what happened to that shirt. It was my favorite shirt.
You know, I
never
see,
got it back. I left it at the beach.
I see these characteristics in my daughter. And let me ask you as a parent, because you got a 12-year-old. And I'll take the unsolicited advice from everyone else. When your kid has tendencies to want to be a perfectionist, how do you tell them, like, yo, it's never going to be perfect? Like, Emmy's the type that'll be coloring yeah. and be like, I made a little mistake. It's ruined. I'm like, gets all upset. I'm like, baby, we all make mistakes. And she'll like have a meltdown. I'm like, yeah. I'm going to draw a cat in an ice cream cone. And I'm like, yo, that's cool, buddy. Do it.
Yeah.
So she'll make a cat, an ice cream cone. And she's like, the cone's not even. Ah, rips it up. She goes, but she wants everything to be perfect. She'll do her homework. And if she, I'll be honest, I went to her kindergarten, back to school, little orientation last night. I'll tell you more about that in a little bit. But I look around the room and the artwork from the kids. I'm not saying my kid's a savant, like, you know, just a regular kid like everyone else. But I do notice her penmanship for a 5-year-old is neater and in the lines more than the other kids.
She
and
I'm has
like,
expectations.
And I'm like, ooh, does she have the, like, it needs to be perfect OCD tendencies that I have? And I'm like, oh, I hope not. I'm like, buddy, yo, you're going to make mistakes. Dad makes mistakes every fucking day. You just try your best. Always do your best and give your best effort. But it can't, I promise you, no one or nothing is perfect. Except for this guy, Kurt Henning, and he died.
Yeah, he's dead. His name was Mr. Perfect. Spot, I found out what happened to my lion shirt, though, after all these years. I texted you a photo.
Oh, Jason brings up a good one. He goes, tell your kid those little mistakes you make. That's what makes me think your painting is special. You know, like try to twist it or something, you know?
Spot gave me a look that's maybe a look that we shouldn't show the photo. It was the happy, like, African kids dancing.
Let's see.
Don't you imagine that all your, like, goodies go to third world countries?
Well, that's the joke, right?
Yeah. I feel like he took it off right after this photo.
They all think the Buffalo Bills won 4 Super Bowls in a row.
Yeah. I love that photo. Anyway. Oh, really? Thank you. So I was in a sort of a mood yesterday, but again, subconsciously.
Yeah.
Right? I wasn't like, man, I'm getting old. I don't do that until I get here on the show and I try to figure out why I was feeling that way. But I was like, well, what am I going to do the rest of the day? So I did the dad thing, you know, and then I had the rest of my night free because I dropped Melody off. And then I finished that Netflix, way back on a Wednesday, that Netflix documentary about Woodstock 99. That shit is wild. That's all I got to say.
You know,
I watched the HBO Max one, and the HBO Max one was really like, what's with the white guilt and the anger that you had? You know, it's like, what was going on in 99 that made white guys so angry? That really was the moral of the story. Because remember, Woodstock 99, they lit the whole place on fire and Fred Durst was riling up the crowd and inciting riots. And it went from what was supposed to be peace and love, Woodstock 69. Kids were not like that in 99. But it was also a failure on the producer's part because they booked the most rageful bands possible. Korn, Limp Bizkit, Kid Rock. I believe Rage was there. Where are they? I don't know. But it's like you expected peace and love when you're hiring the most rageful bands of the time to play. It's a different time. So I watched the one on Netflix. It's a 3-part series. Highly recommend it, even if you didn't like that music or didn't care about Woodstock 99. I really wished I was there. I was working back at the studio. You guys remember I told that story. I was working, but not on site. I was in the studio. And man, dude, it's just a great story and a great failure, according to the documentary and according to the footage and according to reality. But if you ask people that went, including my friends that were there, time of their life.
Is that one of those good, is that one of those good omissions that you could say and no one would call you out on?
What?
Like, oh, Covino. Oh, yeah. I worked Woodstock 99.
I did, but I didn't.
Yeah, but like when he says he worked it, he was the guy back in New York at the studio while the other people were at Woodstock.
Recording the live audio.
Yeah. So, If you wanted to, in a conversation, say that, no one would call out your semantics. It would be like an omission lie. Like,
yeah, I know.
It was Woodstock 99.
The reality, though,
I worked it.
The reality was I got left out of the cool crew that got to go. Man. And honestly, because I was more of a diligent person at this, believe it or not, sat there with a little monitor. I got to watch the live feed. And if Seven Dust was performing, I'm also recording it on like that cassette. And they're like, oh, that was great. But LeJean cursed in the song. You got to cut that and edit it and let's get it on the air in the next 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. So that was my job that whole weekend. And when you watch this back, you're like, something was going, something was in the water, pun intended, because it got all the kids sick. Mm-hmm. But something was going on with the psyche of kids, us, in that era. I was a young man in 99.
Yeah, I'll be honest.
Because they were way angry, Rich.
My interest level is low, but you could convince me to watch it if you're telling me like, yo, bro, it's like out of control.
Out of control.
I just have such a little interest. Like, know what it's, I'm interested in watching? I'm interested in watching, now that we watched the Manti Te'o documentary,
yeah.
I have not yet caught Untold, Operation Flagrant Foul, about the referee who fixed the games and all that.
And one was great.
I haven't watched the other.
Shout out to the professor and Hot Sauce.
I haven't watched the other Untolds, and I heard they're fantastic. They're great. I was at the barbershop yesterday with our boy Addy.
Yeah.
And he always has TV playing in the background. I'm like, yeah, I want to watch, but I don't want to watch because he had a Untold Flagrant Foul on.
Yeah.
And he has not seen the Manti Te'o one. I'm like, you haven't seen the Manti Te'o one, but you've seen this one? But
different things appeal to different people.
Yeah, I'm pretty interested in watching that one.
Woodstock 99 is not about Korn. It's not about Kid Rock. My takeaway is the weak-minded people that are out there, are you susceptible to the mob mentality and turning into an animal? It's very much Lord of the Flies. It's like, here's all these kids fucking raging. Music sparked them, set them off. They were already mad, right? Because it was hot and water prices were high and they're like, stick it to the man. Fuck you guys. Limp Bizkit's like, break stuff. And they're like, break stuff. So then this guy breaks stuff. Someone else jumps in. This guy lights some shit on fire. That guy lights some shit on fire. And then it's like a perfect storm of like idiots. Honest,
it seems like a bunch of like idiotic, like 20-year-old white dudes.
It's mob mentality.
I'd be aggravated watching, but maybe I'll watch.
How like a riot ensues almost, right? And then the bands perpetuated this because, you know, I don't know. That's what they do. It's like, all right, ready? It's who do you blame? Do you blame Limp Bizkit for being Limp Bizkit? That's why you hired them. That's who they are. Or do you expect Fred Durst to be like, all right, chill. All right, everybody. I'm trying to make history, but you need to relax.
Well, that's not his job. No, but you saw what happened with, what is it, Astroland?
Yeah, but that, I think that honestly was different because he was seeing, or maybe he wasn't, seeing people getting trampled. This is just people breaking shit. This wasn't about watching people get hurt, even though a lot of people did get hurt. It's oceans of people, 250,000 people up and down. And they're trying to blame like Fred Durst. Fred Durst is doing what he does. Let's bring it back to the lion on my t-shirt. Lions do what a lion does. You know, like you can't blame, then don't hire these rageful bands if you want a peaceful outcome. Made no sense. And then they handed out candles to these kids.
Well, I'm thinking.
It ended in fire.
I'm just looking because at Astroworld, and I forgot it was in Houston, Houston Astros. Travis Scott not stopping down is what got him a ton of shit. I think these people benefited that, what, no one died?
If people got severely hurt, but I'm saying
if people had died at Woodstock 99.
It was not the story.
No, but I'm saying if Woodstock had people die, I think the narrative would be different. Because it's like, yeah, these rock bands were like, yeah, keep tearing shit up. If people had died, they would have been accountable. They're just lucky no one died.
Well, if you're a rock band and you're performing Woodstock, there's two ways to look at it. You're trying to make history and you're trying to set that crowd off. Right? You're trying to get people to fucking get ballistic. And when you see that, it's probably a thrill. Like, holy fuck, look at everybody going wild for our shit. But now you expect like Fred Durst to be the peacemaker of this event? In his mind at the time, he's probably like, fuck yeah, this is crazy. You know, but he does say, it's not my fault. But anyway, I watched that last night. It's wild to see all these years later. You know, I wish I was there. Jordan's like, I think it was good you weren't there. I was like, nah, I wish I was there. Because all my friends that were there said it was the time of their life.
Maybe the greatest. There was a bunch of rageful white dudes. They would have been like, kill the Vato. No, you don't know.
I blend, bro. I'm chameleon. You know, I'm right there in the middle.
Well, let's break things up because you said you said a few minutes ago, it's not all about corn. No. However,
it is.
It is all about it corn. Is. Spot, can you play the video that's sweeping the nation? Corn boy? I mean, is he the modern day? I like turtles. Is he the modern day? Apparently, is he the new kid that's all the rage?
I mean, are you mad that he stole your title or no?
Because I mean, I have gone on and on about how much I love sweet corn. I mean,
you're the original corn boy.
This kid.
Oh, wait, I'm sorry. You're corny boy.
Has been remixed. This kid became all the rage. I'm surprised we haven't mentioned them yet. Sarah came in this morning, right before we went on the air, and she said, "Have you guys not talked about corn boy yet?"
I sent them to you.
And you did. And I've seen them a million times. To me, yeah, we just have not talked about corn boy yet.
Yeah, he's sweeping the nation.
Hit it.
Me, I really like corn.
What do you like about corn?
It's cold. A good corn enough. It has the juice. And when I'm old, you put it in It's cold. I can tell you all about it.
He tried it with butter and everything changed.
Kids love corn, man. Corn boy. I still love corn.
I love corn boy. You see, did you see corn boy? He's a little older now. He's people know he's the guy hiding behind the tree. He saw the, when a corn truck fell.
No, he sings Dead Giveaway.
Did you see that meme?
His name is Charles Ramsey.
Corn boy. Look, there he is. When a truck of corn spilled.
Oh, that's hilarious. I never saw that. Corn boy. Corn boy is sweeping the nation. Not the band corn. Corn boy.
The kid isn't wrong. Is there anything better? I'll be honest. You were here the other day.
It has no healthy benefit to you.
You were here. Delicious. No, you're right. You were here the other day. And yeah, we had some steak. It was good. Yeah, we had some cocktails and you brought some seltzers. But you know what my favorite thing was? Corn.
Corn.
Sop it up with some butter and salt and pepper and sometimes maybe even a little tahini and some juices. And
it's got the juice. Ooh. This is like corn porn right now.
Oh, I've always
Just
known
give
about
me some Jonathan Davis in
I've
the background.
I've always known about sweet corn, load. But to me, it's like, I don't know why we don't appreciate it more.
Corn, you kidding me?
Yeah.
I used to have a song when I was a kid, bro. I had my own song. I swear to God. I used to sing, Steven, don't you remember you used to sing that song? I remember, Mom.
What do you like about corn?
It's cold.
It's got the juice.
A good corn enough. It has the juice.
It got the juice.
And when the most beautiful thing.
Most beautiful thing, man.
It's cold.
I used to mix my corn. I still do with my mashed potatoes.
I mean,
I like my mashies mixed with corn. That's what I say all the time.
Should I tell my kids when they do that, like, I don't know, 3 days a week, that they're pulling a Steve?
Yeah,
you know,
man.
Who does that? You know, I'm going to tell Emmy you invented
Uncle
it.
Steve invented that. Mix your mashies
Emmy,
with the corn.
When you mix your mashed potatoes with corn.
You got to sing the Les Miserables song.
I like my... I like my taters with some corn.
There it is, my mash.
For me, I really like corn.
What do you like about corn?
Ever since I was told that corn was real, it tasted good.
Did you think corn wasn't real?
But when I tried it with butter, everything changed. I love corn. Corn.
Do you think everyone should be eating corn?
No, not everyone has to like it to be the best.
Yeah.
Everyone just has to try it. Have a bite.
What else are your favorite things?
I play a variety of games. Hide and seek, tag.
I love this kid.
Never love a monster. Yeah, mostly corn. I mean, then look at this then. I can't imagine a more beautiful thing. It's corn.
It's got the juice.
Look at this.
It's corn.
Because corn is awesome.
Can you describe corn to someone who's never tasted it before?
A big lump with knobs. It has the juice. It's the part that mostly makes me like the corn.
How much do you think corn should cost?
$1. I hope you really have a corn-tastic day.
A corn-tastic day?
Have a corn-tastic day.
You know what? The dude is right.
I want to. Could I adopt that kid? Could I take him? I think it would make a great addition to my family.
He's easy to please.
I mean, I'll have corn every day with that kid.
Yeah.
But it is.
Kid?
It is a treat.
I got corn.
Yep.
That's easy, man. I need that. Yeah. Can I trade him?
I'll have that kid. I have a question.
You have my pain in the ass daughter. I'll trade you.
Yeah, Mexican style. We did that the other day with some mayo, cheese, and a little spice. Ooh, I love that. That's fantastic. But if you're trying to do a little quickie corn.
What's your favorite line in that song? To me, it's so obvious.
It's got the juice. Yes,
it's got the juice. That shit is so funny.
Do you throw the corn on the grill or do you
love that
or
kid.
Do you boil it?
I love that kid. Does that kid come with corn?
I steam it on the grill. I mean, corn-tastic.
Mm, cone. Like, you know me, I like cone. Cutting off. I get in the husk.
Yeah.
You cut off the end of the one of the sides and you pour water down it. And then you just put it right on the grill and it steams inside the husk. And then you just eat that.
Oh, elote is definitely one of the greatest things.
It's got the juice.
Elote. It's got the juice. All right. Well, hey, hopefully
you've seen a kid that excited over a vegetable. But you know what? Like, corn doesn't even qualify as a vegetable. Like, every kid loves fucking corn.
Who doesn't love corn?
Who doesn't like corn? The only thing is, like, you know, like I said, as far as health benefits,
it just doesn't have much.
It doesn't have a whole lot.
It's the least vegetable, right?
And it just goes right through your body.
Yeah. What's that meme? It says like something about when you eat corn, it's never goodbye. It's see you later. Because, well, you know why.
I mean, you know why. I mean,
you know why.
You know why. If you don't get a close up.
Kid, definitely.
I was going to say, if you got little kids, you get a close up look, not just yourself.
If this kid doesn't know, man, he's going to be so excited.
If you forgot what you had for dinner last night, but you have kids,
he's like, it's cone.
Oh, corn. Ben, that's right. We had corn last night. Yeah. Oh, geez, we had corn. Cone.
This kid must be thrilled.
Cone.
So anyway, that song, believe it or not, is sweeping the nation. So we go from corn to corn.
Gabe is right. There's no right answer. Like, you can't shit on someone for boiling or grilling corn because truthfully, either way, tastes good.
You know what? You can't say that.
Can't say that
for
about
a
many
lot
things.
Of things. No,
you know, many things. It's like, well, you can't put pizza. You can't reheat shit in the microwave. Some people
like,
would
like Brussels sprouts, right?
You can't. I
would argue though. Like, you can't like boiled.
It's
barf,
the equivalent
grilled. Yes,
it's the equivalent of like boiling versus grilling a hot dog. You're gonna get some sort of caramelization and like extra flavor out of putting corn on the grill.
You know what you have to do though? You have to convince kids though that the burnt part
cornholio
is good. Because kids will assume bad. Like if I give Emmy like corn
really
on the grill,
not.
but if it chars and it's like what you would want as an adult, like, ooh, there's some char on the corn. My kids would be like, it's burnt. And I'm like, no, that's the best part.
Jordan, and I don't know if this is true, but I assume.
Tell me she doesn't like corn
research.
And Mexican food. It's
no,
over.
No, she insists that burnt parts of anything are not.
Carcinogens.
Yeah,
I know.
Are not
Sarah's,
beneficial.
Sarah's,
so why
mom
would you,
Sarah's mom is like that.
So why would you force that on your kid?
No,
I know, but it tastes good. I'm like, no, I'm good. I'll eat that shit. Jordan's
no, it's bad for you. Like if we put bacon in the oven, which by the way, Spot taught me that years ago, and I have not turned back. I haven't fried bacon since
it's got the juice.
I've baked it because you bake it in the pan, they stay like the long strips, and it's a better cook. But I'll fucking take the burnt remnants off the pan with my finger afterwards, like. And Sarah's like, don't eat that. That's like the burnt carcinogens.
Yeah,
and I'm
so
like,
why
I
would
know.
You tell Emmy to eat that stuff? You eat it. I would be like, no, I'll eat that.
Because
eating
care.
The fatty bacon's fine, but the carcinogens on the pan, they're going to kill you.
All right. Well, hey, welcome to a Patreon Way Back Wednesday, the last day. Today's the last day, right, of August.
I have a question for you. Today is the last day of August. Before we get into the hard-hitting Rich Davis story.
Everyone gets the feed today. Everyone gets the video today?
Yeah.
Does everyone get the show, like even non-patrons?
Yeah, so you better bring it, man.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, well, hey, welcome, newbies. Join in on the fun.
We haven't seen in a while. Thank you. Covino and Rich, still doing it. Still having fun.
Covino does, by the way, Lisa. She said, does anyone buy pre-cooked bacon? I feel like that's a Covino thing, don't you?
From Costco, yeah, sometimes. Just heat it up.
Yeah. Sort of gross to me, but I get it. If you're on the go. To me, that
anything gross about it. If you tasted it, it's fantastic. Yeah. Bacon.
It's true. It's not like real bacon, super healthy. It's a shortcut.
Making bacon. So, Spot has COVID. Yes, Gabe. I don't know. Hope not.
I do not, because I took a rapid test this morning.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, very responsible of you.
Why Thank
would
you,
I
Spot.
Bring, why would I want to bring you shit?
I don't know. Because there's always things going around. I think that's what it is.
Yeah, I mean, just like we say, it's like other sicknesses don't cease to exist.
Of course.
I just wanted to, because it's and, very, you I know, have a very aggressive, whatever I have. It's
when,
very aggressive.
When seasons change, there's not a fucking person in a circle of people that isn't a little under the weather at some point. That's just life.
My eyes are still watering.
Are the seasons changing? Because it's 110 degrees out right now.
Yeah. I saw Paris Hilton said it's hot today.
My car thermometer yesterday said 109. I'm like, I know that's not like the truth because it's just a hot car, but still, I'm like, 109? Jesus Christ.
Well,
it was 91
in the morning. Jeez.
The reason I dove into the Woodstock 99 documentary is because I was sick of listening to the Yankee game. Now, I wasn't able to watch the Yankee game because it was on Amazon Prime, but it was also blacked out because they were playing the California Angels, right?
Mm-hmm.
So because they have their contract with the cable provider, yeah, it was blacked out. I couldn't watch it. And I'm like, man, I'm so sick of this shit. It's really annoying. And I know a lot of people deal with this more often than I do, but it's really annoying. And I get it. Innovate or die. Baseball made contracts with Apple TV and Amazon. And instead of a lot of games airing on local affiliates and things like that, they now air on Apple and Amazon, whatever.
I thought it was cool to see Al Michaels. Was it? Yeah, I saw Al Michaels on his first Amazon broadcast. And yeah, I was like, oh, cool. Him and Kurt Herbstreit.
You're trying to appeal to younger audiences. I get it. But remember the fan base that you're isolating. Your old-ass baseball fans who are very confused by, like, where's the game right now? And that's fine. I'm not here to harp on that. But I don't think it does any good.
You can find it if you're
for
not
a struggling
a
sport.
So you're talking
oh, yeah, that. I went all lengths. I went to Cody to try to find this game. I went to Facebook trying to find any feed. Couldn't find it.
Well, you're not a Yankee fan group?
Yeah, what do you mean?
Oh, no, I had the same issue. Mets are playing the Dodgers, right?
Yeah.
So yesterday, for me,
yeah,
the game was blacked
sucks
out.
Sucks because but they're in L.A. and
I was out and about. I had the parent-teacher thing anyway, but I watched a little of the game. And
yeah, I want to hear about that.
It's if you just find a Yankees fan group. I found the Mets fan group where there's just one.
But where?
I just searched. What? Facebook.
Yeah, yeah. No, I did
my
that.
Buddy Chris.
There's nothing streaming.
My buddy
yesterday.
Chris hit me up and he goes, yeah, there's one stooge, that some like Mets nerd on Long Island or something that
who streams the
every
game.
Night.
Yeah.
He's like, here we go. 3, 2, 1. And he just streams the game. And it's clear. It's not like there's his
usually,
phone. It's usually, he's just the idiot.
Trust me. I know this trick.
Yeah.
But there's always no one streaming. No one was streaming this game yesterday. But
a lot of times they're private groups, so you have to prove like you're a Yankees fan, like
maybe I'm not
that you're
right
not a
groups,
bot or something. Yeah,
but I was searching and whatever. But my point in bringing this up is I don't think it does any good for a struggling sport to make it more difficult to watch, right? It's like when you call customer service and you're just trying to pay the bill, but they're making it difficult. Like, look, I'm trying to pay, you're making this difficult, right? Certain things should be easy. Like, hey, I'm just trying to support this team, that's all. Why do I gotta jump through hoops? Where is it? Can I find it? Can I watch? And I realized that's sort of why, and this is my own ignorance here, okay? My own ignorance completely.
Agreed. Admit.
No. But I think you might agree with me. Like, there's something about baseball that was always easy for me to understand, right? Meaning, Saturday, it's either going to be on at, like, depending on who they play and where they are. And, you know, it's like a 1 o'clock game, all right? It's probably on right now.
You're such a dope.
You don't even know where
I'm
going.
No, I know what you're saying. You're saying the you like baseball because traditionally it is the most typically.
It's 105, 405, or 705.
Yeah, 105, 405, or 705. And you know the channel.
How it works,
yeah,
right?
Because there's
it's
no
air on this. Oh, what day is it? Oh, it's Friday night. It's game's on around 7. All right.
705.
It's a matter of two channels. I know where to find it. I kind of got a feel for when it's on. I know how it works. I have never till this day have been able to understand and follow how a basketball schedule works and how to find the team and the game. And it really, this has been my struggle. There's no consistency or anything that I can understand about how a basketball schedule works or feel for when it's on. You know what I mean? It's almost, it's just a matter of luck
for
me to
find really,
it.
There's really,
there's no, I can't figure
no
it out.
There's no rhyme or reason.
I mean, aside from looking, you know, looking up the schedule and figuring it out, I don't have the feel for where do I find it and when is the game on. And that's part of the reason why I can't be consistent. I'm going to try my best to stay on top of things moving forward because I want to watch this shit. But I feel like that inconsistency and that inability to figure out the routine really has prevented me from diving in even further.
Basketball is the one that's a little tricky.
That's where I'm going.
100%.
That's where I was going.
I just find it funny that, yes, of course, baseball, your favorite sport.
Or how about football? You know exactly when the games are on. You know and exactly if and how you could find them.
Yeah, there's a Thursday night game.
That's it.
A Sunday night and a Monday night. All the others.
Don't tell me that doesn't help.
All the others are 1 o'clock or 4 o'clock, depending on.
Basketball feels like a hodgepodge of like, I don't know when it's on.
Yeah. Lakers have 2 days off and then they play back-to-back games and then they do that. Oh, yeah,
drives me berserk. And that's how I'm starting to feel with baseball. I'm like, what network? Is it on Amazon? Is it on Apple? Is it on MLB?
Yeah, but who doesn't have
ESPN
Amazon?
Game of the Week? Isn't
that what the internets is for?
Yeah, you look it up. I get it, but I don't have that feel for it. You know what I mean?
If you were a passionate Laker fan.
Yeah.
You would have like apps on your phone.
No, if you're a passionate Laker fan, you have a feel for like when that game's on. And where, you know what I mean? Like you just have a feel like, oh yeah.
So you're not a passionate fan of any NBA team.
I don't have a grasp of that instinct, the schedule.
Well, you know what you don't have?
And baseball's starting to fuck with me.
Let me tell you what you don't have though. And I don't have it either, so I can't complain.
Tech savvy.
You don't have local television.
Yeah, it messes it up.
And now if you lived in New York and you wanted to watch the Knicks, it's easy. It's on MSG. Or the games that are on TBS or TNT.
Wouldn't have a grasp of, and you still need cable.
Yeah, but I'm saying you don't have the Lakers channel here because you don't have LA thing. So the only time you're watching the NBA is if you're scrolling through and it's like, oh, TBS on a Tuesday night. No, they're playing the Bucks game. Like, I mean, that's how you're catching it.
Figuring out networks for football can sometimes be confusing.
It's Fox or CBS every Sunday, yeah, NBC like, Sunday night.
But at least I know the schedules are consistent. Like
who's covering what game?
NFC is Fox. AFC is CBS.
Oh, there you go. It's easy.
It's just wild when you're trying to support like certain teams or sports that are struggling. It's like blacked out.
Well, baseball is actually not struggling.
Get out of here.
Ratings are up, believe it or not.
No, they're up. But in the grand scheme of winning over new fans, it's not the league leader. Well, you know, look, I'm the biggest Yankees fan you could find because I'm not watching any stupid Reds game. You know, so I'm a big fan anyway. It just dawned on me like, yeah, this confusion that I'm experiencing of where to find the game right now is the reason why I can't fully dive into basketball the way I would or want to.
It doesn't have the simple, you know what Covino likes spot? It doesn't have the simple, not consistency, predictability.
Predictability, whatever.
Covino loves the predictability that the Yankees are going to play every day at 4:05 West Coast time, unless they're on the West Coast, and they're going to have either a Monday or Thursday off, but the other 5 to 6 days a week, bam. You can guarantee that at 4 o'clock when he's scratching his ass on the West Coast, the Yankee game starts.
I rotate my ass scratching around that shit.
So there you go.
You know, so I get it. I live it. I have a feeling for it. Like, ooh, the game, I'm pretty sure the game's up.
Some of the Apple broadcasts are rough, but again, Apple, you have. If you have... You could get access to those games. The games Amazon football.
I'm right there
has
in the middle
fantastic.
Of the pocket, right? Where, okay, the game, I could watch it. I got the Apple app. I got Amazon. But again, it was blacked out because they were playing the Angels. Yeah, so even though I had Amazon, I still couldn't watch it, which is annoying as hell. But if you have a slightly older guy, they really don't get it. And I know Rich thinks everybody does, but they don't.
No, you just have to walk. You have to deal with some. You have to have the older person have the open mind to say, I want to learn even a little. Because once they want to learn even a little, it opens up their ability to do these things. My dad, right?
Yeah.
You know my dad used to do every week? Oh, Richie, can you send me the link of your Fox radio show? So every week I'd have to be like, let me go get the link and text it to him. And I was just happy to text it to him because he was supportive and wanted to listen. But I'm like, Dad, you know, on your phone, on your iPhone, see the podcast button? He's like, oh, right there. I go, click on that. Just search it. Don't even have to finish Covino. Type in COV.
Either COVID comes up or
COVID Covino.
It's great.
And
I love that story.
Oh, there it is. Covino. See? Right there.
There it is.
So it's
I still have to explain to people how to put our podcast on their phones.
But Spot, if someone's willing to learn, right? It's like being intimidated.
It's very difficult.
I'm willing to learn the basketball schedule this year.
If you are willing to learn how to fix something in your house, if you're willing to learn how to do home improvement, do something technological, it's the willingness. A lot of time it's the initial intimidation, like, something new, I don't want to. That's usually it. Like your intimidation makes you quit from the start.
You know what else should be more convenient? Now I know there's ways and I know there's Google, okay? I get it. I get Google exists.
Yeah.
I understand. Spot has reminded me time and time again.
Google exists for a reason.
Therefore, I don't ask spot questions anymore. I go to Google.
How's that working out?
It has most of the answers, but not all of them.
Yeah.
I'm still there if you need me.
But I really think there should be a more convenient way, too, to be like...
Like Google?
Oh, Jordan said the other day, you ever see... Oh, what's that movie with the aliens? And they're like prawns. Project... Something number 9.
Oh.
Oh, District 9.
District 9.
You ever see District 9? I heard it's great.
It stunk.
Like, is that like Cloverfield? That's my mindset.
District 9 was pretty interesting.
And by the way, I went to Netflix and I searched District 9 and Cloverfield did come up. So I must be on the right track.
Was it satiric?
No, it's like documentary style alien movie. I don't know.
Wasn't it satire?
But I'm like,
racism?
Well, where can I find it? Instead of going to each and every fucking streaming service I have now to see if they have it, there should be an easier way to find these things. Like, where could I watch this movie? You know, like convenience.
There is.
What is it? What's the app? Find like the movie app?
IMDb will tell you when movies are, where they're on or with it. Or if you search.
I'm always on IMDb. There's no like real easy option that I know of. You can Google it. Like, it'll tell you sometimes, but I want to know. At Fire TV, yeah.
If you just hold the mic button down and you say, what movie do you want to watch? District 9? Bloop. District 9. It'll come up. You click on it and it'll give you the ways to watch.
All the
it'll
options.
It'll tell you if either you have to pay for it, rent it, or the networks it's on.
All the options? It really does?
Most of them.
I'm going to try that shit when I get home.
Go bloop.
Yeah.
You know, you hold the button.
District 9.
District 9.
And it gives.
And it'll tell you, watch now. You can either, it'll say like watch with, it has to be a linked
app. I'm like, what is it streaming on? I don't know. Google it. And I'll Google it. And it doesn't really give me a clear answer. Right?
Like, it's like.
Well, what the fuck?
Like, I've watched.
Why can't they make this easy? I'm trying to support this.
Like Tubi. I watch a lot of movies on Tubi because it's free.
My point is, all these things tie together because I'm sure there's an easy solution for some people, but not all people. And I'm just trying to make it easier for boneheads like me. When you're trying to support something or pay for something, it shouldn't be jumping through hoops. Like a pay-per-view. You know how difficult it is to get a pay-per-view sometimes? I get pay-per-views all the time. And I'm like, wait, what do I have to do? I have to sign in the app first? And then I have to pay on the app and then put the code in to make it work on the TV? Like, what the fuck? What do I have to do? Where is it? How do I find this pay-per-view?
Jesus Christ.
It shouldn't be that difficult.
That
and I'm not like completely in the dark.
Just shit out some corn.
Like if you're an older guy, like I could see how an older guy would be like, I guess I'm not watching this pay-per-view. I can't find it.
Corn didn't say goodbye. It said see you later.
Corn never says goodbye.
Gross. Oh, that pumpkin spice latte fucking just.
Oh, you got a pumpkin spice latte?
Shit? You took a shit right now?
I had a stomachache. I was like, you don't have to say take a shit. I was just had a stomachache. Why being all gruesome?
I mean, you disappeared, dude.
What do you want me to tell you?
That's wild, though. Anyway. Like
you ran out of
convenience.
Here. You really just took a shit?
I'm not talking about it.
That was very quick. I'm very impressed.
Why we're on the east. We're on the
and
air,
the west.
Why are, why are you drinking pumpkin spice lattes? It's 150 degrees out.
It's iced, and they started yesterday, so I said to Sarah, hey, if you're going to stop by Starbucks, grab me one. I haven't had one in a year. So pumpkin let me see spice. I don't like it, to be honest.
No, they're disgusting.
I'm not a fan, but I figured I haven't had that taste in a year. So
they're garbage.
Well, anyway.
Pumpkin spice lattes.
I heard you, what you were saying, and I'm amazed that you have a Fire Stick. That's how you watch TV or Roku? I forget.
Bloop. Roku? What do you think? I'm Weird Al?
So what
Fire Stick.
Okay.
I've been a Fire Stick guy.
Okay.
For a long time
as
now.
Am I.
Bloop.
Bloop.
District 9.
Yeah, bloop. District 9. Even just go to the search thing, District 9. And you know what it'll do? It'll be like, you could rent on Amazon. You could do this. You could do that. It gives you every option. So what you're saying exists. You just didn't do it.
Well, now I know.
Yeah, no. I've done that during the holidays.
That's half the battle.
You know what you do that during the holidays? It'll be like, I don't know.
Not everybody has
I want to watch a fucking Elf. You'd be like, Elf. Bloop. You could rent it here, buy it here. It's airing here. It's on HBO. Like, it'll tell you. So.
Bloop.
So you're just going to sit here the rest of the show with my butt?
I feel good.
No, did you wipe? I mean, how'd you do it so fast?
Hack your Fire Stick. You don't have to worry about the hassles.
I was just going
to
ask you this. So, you know, I'm complaining. And I'm not the only one. Like, Rich and Spot have this crazy ability to make it like I'm the craziest guy.
I mean, it's not crazy.
Meanwhile, my other friends are like, yeah, man, this fucking sucks. Can't watch the game. Blah, blah. Everybody's complaining about it.
But who? A bunch of old, angry guys?
Oh, but it's so simple.
Dude,
I know. I'm the only guy. What I'm trying to do is relate to the everyman.
You're trying to relate to the dummy that can't navigate Amazon.
I'm talking about the games and everything. Like, nothing's as easy as it should be in a world of convenience, right? So... And I'm not the only guy. I'm talking to all my friends, and they're all saying the same thing. Like, yeah, this fucking blows. Why ain't the game on WPIX? Right? They're all mad about the same stuff.
Do you hear that? What you just said? Your old school friends are like, why is the game not on?
Rich's friends are the best. Mine are the dumbest. I get it.
I mean, that's
like
a fact,
the amazing ability to make it seem like I'm the craziest guy. I'm the only one. When I'm the only one relating to people. You're the one acting like you're the smartest dude going. So
what you're saying is insane.
Right. Just everyone I talk to then has the same.
How many times a year is a Yankee game on like Amazon or Apple? Maybe 5 to 10 times a year?
No, 20% of the games.
20% of the games?
Yeah, because that's what the local contracts had.
I can't feel like 25. What's 20% of 160?
I believe the local affiliates had 20% of the games. And they lost them out to Apple and Amazon and everything else.
You think 32 Yankees games are not on Yes or PX?
It was either 20% or 20 games. I could be confusing them. But anyway, my buddy hit me back and he's complaining about the games too. I mean, my friends and other people I know are complaining way more than me. I'm just relating to the masses. I deal with it. I listen to the radio. I'm fine. So...
What do you got? Your little earbud in with AM radio?
Yeah, man. I listen to the broadcast. Yeah, I'm fine. I love listening to sports on the radio. I do. So I'm good. I'm getting lots of complaints. So I'm like, okay, well, I guess there's a lot of people on the same page, like not liking this. But I always have a friend, and even one of your friends, Rich. So not just my friends. One of your friends said this to me recently, that they could hook me up. There's always a guy who knows a guy. Or you could get one like on some sort of Amazon black market where you can get a Fire Stick totally hacked with all the pay-per-views like for like $199.
Ooh. Yeah, I'm not interested.
Apollo TV with a Fire Stick is the one I was told about yesterday.
I mean,
but everybody knows a friend that has like, no, man, I don't pay for anything, man. I got them all for free.
You could probably hack it. Like, hack it for you.
Yeah, it's unethical.
I don't know about that.
I mean, Cody's is the most I do. It's unethical.
It's all unethical.
That shit don't even work for me anymore.
Yeah, says the guy who's watching a stream that a guy does on a Facebook group of the Mets game.
That's ooh, hypocrite pants right here?
That's unethical.
I pay for MLB TV.
But I'm saying, you said there's a guy that does it. That's unethical.
Untrue.
Completely
true. If I pay for it.
In order for you to watch a game, you'd have to have cable.
I pay for it.
No, I pay for it too.
No, but you said, didn't you say there's a guy that does a stream?
Yeah.
There's a guy that streams the Mets game.
That's unethical.
Okay. I am not doing any. I pay $100 or something a year for MLB app for Mets games.
Why would you have to watch someone else's stream?
Because there's three games a year that's blacked out.
Hold on.
Okay.
And I pay for.
He's exactly right. There's no way to get it.
And I pay for Netflix, Amazon, Hulu, something else. And I still have to. So I still have to pay to watch a movie when I have all these services?
Do you think they act for free?
Just saying. Why should I pay for all this shit. Why isn't it available?
He's right. He's right. He's right on this one.
What do you mean?
What you're doing is unethical there. That is. So you can't say, like, oh, that's unethical, but you do the same thing.
Yeah, there's no option.
You can't pick and choose ethics.
There is an option. You'd have to have cable.
For three games?
That's the option.
I pay for MLB. Yeah.
So do I.
I pay for a Sunday ticket.
I pay for MLB.
And Spectrum.
And I don't have it.
Spectrum pays to carry that game. So you're just saying to Spectrum, no, fuck you.
Once again, it's because he does it, so it's the
way. Fuck you, Spectrum.
No, stealing.
Cut your losses. I'm going to watch for free on a Facebook
page. How do you not see the difference between stealing a fight?
How do you not
see
the difference? Right,
You're justifying.
Stealing a fight is not... Okay. All right, we'll agree to disagree.
There's nothing to disagree. You're streaming off of a guy's illegal stream.
What's good for the goof?
It's the same thing.
Good for the gander.
How is it not the same thing?
Because I pay for the MLB app. It's just blacked out. It's blacked out in this area. So when I'm out and about, and my MLB app doesn't work.
With that.
And you know why it's blacked out? Because they've paid for the rights to broadcast it locally.
Sometimes it's blacked out spot because of attendance also. Not for the Dodgers, but it's blacked out for attendance, like in Jacksonville and certain areas when they don't sell out.
Dude, Do you know there's people that stream these fights too illegally on Facebook the same exact way? It's that's still illegal. It's just because you're doing it doesn't make it not illegal or not and unethical. I'd say it's more unethical than illegal, even though it's technically illegal. It's like you're not really. It's like cutting the tag off a mattress. You know,
Chris Frey has a good tip.
You know those mattress tags.
He goes, Sunday ticket is discounted for students. Sign up for a class at a community college. Drop the class. It's $100 for students and way more for regular people.
That's a good one.
Interesting.
Anyway, thank you. Yeah, jailbreak the Fire Stick. There's always someone who
VPNs.
Has these.
You guys need to investigate VPNs.
VPNs, all that stuff. So anyway.
I don't use them.
People make it more difficult than it has to be sometimes. And I'm not the only guy. I'm expressing the sentiments that I see amongst people that I deal with. Everyone Rich deals with is the best. I get that.
I just don't deal with people, I guess, that have trouble using Amazon.
I mean, hey, dude, I guess you deal with the best people ever. I'm telling you.
Or like, people that know how to navigate. I mean, I get it. You prefer the game be on your MLB app and Michael K calling the game. But once in a blue moon, the game's on Amazon.
I need Michael K's big head.
Not using Amazon, to me. Come on, dude.
Not everybody has it, man. Not everybody has it.
Not everyone knows that Amazon?
I guess not. And even if you do have it, I have Amazon, still couldn't watch the game last night. Fucking blows.
Yeah, you're talking about the rarest of rare occurrences. It's on a different network, and the team is playing your hometown team, and, you know, the Angels.
Jason Brown's with you. He says he's paying for MLB, The league has blacked out 3 games, almost out of 200. Sorry.
No problem.
I'll watch those 3 games illegally, but it still doesn't make it.
Right.
Well, they're getting my money. I paid Major League Baseball.
He even said it. I'll watch the games illegally. Like, I have no problem with you doing it. But to say that, because I pay for it, it's ethical. You're lying to yourself and us. That's okay.
I hate to admit it, Spence, right?
I mean, I'm the greatest guy.
I do it too. I mean, I was looking for it. I couldn't find a stream. Told you I was looking for it.
I mean, I don't have a problem with you doing it. Do it. I do the same thing.
I was mad as hell.
I would justify it the same way you do.
Same way.
I would, but it's still wrong.
I was looking for it. I couldn't find a stream.
I would do the same justification, but it's still wrong.
Anyway, did I tell you about the mouse in the house?
No. You have a mouse in your house?
Mouse in the house, man. Every night, I got a new routine every night.
Oh, sometimes that could get tricky because you think you might get it and it might not be the only one.
Well,
you don't know if you have 1, 2, 5, a family. You don't know if it's a fuck. Who knows?
You got a new nickname according to Key.
Who's Key?
Unethical Davis.
Oh, he's free today. That's why he's here.
Unethical Davis. Yeah. Look at all the cheapskates. But at least they're not trying to get the show for free. They're just chiming in when it's free.
I mean, that's the point.
Does that make sense?
I want to get people hooked.
Yeah.
Well, I have a new routine. This is a pup date. And I bring the dog. Jordan speaks with an accent now.
Are you happy to see him? Are you happy to see him? Say hi to him.
Say hi to the puppy. Your daddy's home.
You know, we get ready for bed.
Southern cheese.
We get, I don't know.
Something happens.
It happens when she talks to the dog. I'm like, okay.
Are you happy to see him?
And then the dog's like,
here he is.
The only thing happy to see me when I'm home. So I'm kind of cool with that. So at night, because it's in a crate at night, I pick it up and she's like,
where's he taking your bed? Where's he taking your bed?
Oh.
And that just means it's bedtime. Documentary's over. Taking the crate in here so I could wind my night up. And, you know, doggy gets in his crate and it's bedtime. So anyway, moving along, bed. And I'm hearing in the bathroom and I hear like, I'm like, what the fuck was this? Anyway, it's middle of the night.
No.
Yeah, middle of the night. And I don't say anything. I'm like, I live in a condo complex. Could be anything, right? Something in the air filters. I don't know. Neighbor, perhaps. And then I like hear more rustling again. But I'm like, this sounds like it's in the bathroom.
Jordan, have a pumpkin spice latte?
Nah, Jordan's
goes right through you.
She's, I can't tell if she's sleeping, you know, like she's sleeping. I'm up, kind of sleeping, but I like I'm being woken by it, and I hear like another like rustling of a thud. Like I'm like, man, that sounded like fuck, what was that? So I was like a little nervous, like, because you're supposed to be the man of the house. And I'm like,
Jordan,
oh, man,
check it out, Jordan.
I had to pull out my nunchucks. By the way, what's your weapon of choice? Fat Boy Slim style.
My hatchet.
I would probably say. Are you asking me to narrow it down from the Four Ninja Turtles or like actual weapon?
Is it Fat Boy Slim or the Crystal Method?
My weapon of choice would be Raphael with his size.
No, like what's your
or Donatello
bedside,
with a bow?
What's your bedside like?
Sword yeah. Like Leonardo.
I have a butterfly now. I do.
Nunchucks. Michelangelo.
I swear to God, I went to Dick's recently. You know they actually sell Dick's there. Unbelievable. I went to Dick's and I'm like, I think I'm gonna buy a T-ball bat. Just in case.
Staples sells staples?
Yeah.
Guy running to Dick's.
I'm going to BJ's right now.
My weapon of choice. I have a baseball bat.
Bedside?
Yeah.
I think I might invest in a little league.
I have like I have a big like a 32-ounce like a legit baseball bat.
I want a little T-ball
bat. You know
what,
Sarah did? And I didn't understand why. And then she's like, I'm like, oh, very smart. Put a sock on it. And I go, hats for bats? Keep bats warm? What are you fucking, Pedro Serrano?
This is like the most I want to strangle Rich moment
I remember
of my
this.
Life. Like, this happens to me on the daily, by the way. When Rich tells me a joke that I told him.
Welcome to my world.
Yeah, but it's like, you're telling the guy. When you tell the guy that told you, that's some annoying shit. Welcome. That's when it's crazy. It's like,
can you believe the Yankees were
but I told you, you put a sock over the bat. And you said, what?
Welcome to my
and I said, because if an intruder grabs the bat, you could slide it off. You're like, I never thought of that. We had this conversation.
Well, apparently, Sarah heard it too, besides
what
you.
If they're so good? Yeah.
Probably, but I said this to from you. Covino. These dummies fucking remember. Everyone watching us probably remembers that.
They hang
the
on your
guy
words.
The guy I talked to doesn't remember that.
I don't listen.
I looked you in the eye. We had a conversation. And you're telling me.
I don't hear you.
So I have a butterfly knife that my Uncle Victor gave me. But I need one of those bats, and I'll put a sock on it.
That flops open and then has the knife?
Yeah. Yeah. By the time I go...
Oh, I thought it was the knife you had with the beautiful butterfly carved on the side of it.
By the time I go like... I'm already probably strangled.
I thought you used Little Buck.
No.
That's my other knife. Where is that?
That's a good knife.
Bring out Little Buck.
I got a knife collection. I do. I have a knife collection.
Little Buck the prominent part?
One day I'll have to show you behind the velvet rope.
I have a knife collection.
So anyway... I'm starting to hear this rustling. I'm like, yo, man, I don't know if Jordan's awake, but I'm hearing some shit. Like, I'm hearing something. And I'm like, something? What is that?
You have a flashlight in your bedroom?
I have a flashlight, like, hidden in my closet.
Did you say
I said flashlight.
Oh, no. I don't.
I definitely
I just have my phone.
Joking. Have both in your...
I have both. Sometimes I put my flashlight in my flashlight.
So here I am. Right. Somebody wants some business, man.
Someone wants to get a really... If someone wants to get a superficial wound...
By the way, it's one of the best gifts I ever got. Little Buck.
You really could, honestly.
I don't remember who gave
you
this.
You could easily kill someone with that.
Wait, if you stab him 50
times.
I
somebody with it.
No,
you can stab him right in the neck,
you go for the jugular.
Yeah, it's pretty good stuff. Little Buck is my envelope opener for the most
part. Just go right for the jugular.
But I'm always packing just in case.
I'll bleed out slowly. You can look at... You know what you do? You stab him in the neck. Hold it there, and you look in their eyes as they slowly bleed out to death.
I don't think you would have it in you to...
Let me show you.
Do you have it more? Do you think... push came to shove, someone attacked you, and it was you or them. You're going to fucking attack. You're going to save your own life if push came to shove. But do you think you'd have an easier time stabbing or shooting someone?
Shooting someone.
Probably the...
Stabbing just seems very natural to me because like I feels like I'm in close combat and I'm just trying to survive.
Stabbing's a very intimate way to kill someone.
A lot of times when someone stabs someone to death, it's usually like the boyfriend or something.
Yeah, but I feel like
the uncle.
I'm struggling.
No, but I'm
so
saying
I feel like I don't have.
God forbid there was an intruder. God forbid some creepo came in with like a fucking long hair and a mask on. And he's like, oh, I'm going to kill your family. Like, do you think you would more easily be like, yeah, motherfucker. Or you think you'd be like, ha, ha, ha. Like, stabbing to me is like, oh, geez, you could feel the knife go into their fucking skin. Oh, that would be.
I think that's easier for me.
And then you go up.
You think?
And then you look in their eyes as they
stabbing's very personal.
As the life slowly fades away.
If you had to murder someone.
Got a rocket in your pocket.
If you had to kill someone in self-defense. Stabbing
twitching.
Just seems ultimately like...
What if I grab the wrong one, though? I think I grab my switchblade, and it's the comb one. I'm like, oh!
Start combing their hair.
Oh,
I mean, wait a second.
No, you grab this one. You're like, you better back off.
Oh, I grabbed the wrong knife.
My dad always had cool switchblades growing up, man. So I always kind of like that.
You better get out of here.
Oh, we still have boxes of those, don't we, Spot? Somewhere?
Oh, they're here.
Really?
Boxes.
Yeah, switchblade clones.
Switchblade clones. You want any? We'll give you some. We also have hand buzzers, too.
Speaking of which,
I want to go through
this. I'm not trying to hijack your story, but you were just saying, like, you thought there might be an intruder, and
no, I'm like,
something's here.
Something's here. We've got a mouse.
Did you see the video? That is terribly sad, but, like, I don't know what. The guy's not going to be charged. Some dude, his girlfriend dumps him, and he goes to her house. And he's, like, knocking on the door. Then he's like, I'm coming in. And the dad's like, back off the porch. I got a gun. The guy's still like, I'm coming in. Fucking dad kills his daughter's boyfriend.
Kills him?
The guy's like, I'm coming in. And the guy's like, fucking blows the guy away. There's a video of it.
Jesus, dude.
It's like, yo, like, to me.
There's a video of it?
I don't. Yeah, they blur out that part, but you see the video of the guy, like, knocking on the door. Then you see, like, the aftermath of him stumbling away.
That's why I need this bat.
Yeah, it's in Ohio. It is like, bro, it is like sad because it's like, yo, this kid was a piece of shit, I'm sure. You know, who's trying to bust into someone's house after a breakup? But if this is some young kid, you think the dad needed to kill him?
Let's see how well Rich knows my story.
You think the dad needed to kill him?
No, absolutely not.
Yes, exactly.
I went to an ex-girlfriend's house after we were broken up. Her dad came out and a wife beat her.
Said she doesn't want to talk to you.
But what was the expression that he used that I use till this day and I think of him? And I say it in his inflection. You know it? I'll tell you. You don't know it. What's doing?
What's doing?
Like, I remember, like, I went there with all this emotion, but I had to pause for a second. I'm like, what's doing? I don't think I ever heard that. Oh my God. I didn't know that expression at the time.
But see, like, morons like Preston.
And I'm like, I'm here to see Jen.
Morons. He goes,
she doesn't want to talk to you.
Morons like Preston are like, well, you shouldn't try to bust down the door then. But yeah, you think some 20-year-old kid
should have been shot and killed?
You don't know.
I don't know how. Like, I have to see it.
What was the story? Was he abusive?
Yeah.
But still, you think dangerous? if someone, I don't know.
Was
I think there's other ways.
Was he armed? I don't know any
you
details.
You want to see the video? I have it.
Yeah. I mean, I don't want. Not really.
I have the unblurred version.
You have the unblurred version?
If you ever want to find anything very gruesome,
Spot took his Amazon Fire Stick and he's like, I want the gruesome version of the shooting.
No, if you ever want to find something gruesome, you just search what it is. So I searched like dad shoots daughter's ex and then just add Reddit at the end and you'll find it.
I only joke when I say morons like Preston, but really, honestly, I'm reading the feedback. Preston, do people really think that, like, if this
kid
didn't,
kid, I don't know.
Like, I mean, there. I guess it needs to be more to the story, but the reality is, you really do think that.
How aggressive is the kid too? That.
I mean, from watching the video, it just seemed like a kid that was like, "Come on," like hit knocking on the door.
I mean,
like
he was pretty aggressive.
Really, I don't know. Gosh,
I mean, to kill him though.
It's not a very. I could show the video because it's not a very like morbid.
I mean, Rich is also the guy who said that Squid Games was the scariest shit he'd ever seen.
It's true. So. It's not a very morbid video.
All right, they play it, Spot.
Nah, that's right. We
don't play the part where he's knocking on the door and cut out where he got shot. Because the knocking on the door is like, you tell me if this kid is threatening enough that
not everybody wants to see.
Yeah, I want you to know if you think this kid is threatening enough that he deserved to be killed.
I mean, I don't think anyone deserves to be killed unless they're trying to kill you. Mm-hmm. But I don't know how threatened his dad felt.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, listen, I get the whole play stupid games, win stupid prizes. I get that whole phrase. But I mean, like, honestly, this kid's life is over now.
I mean, what's the kid trying to do?
Trying to get to the girl.
I'm sure he wasn't expecting that.
I got a gun.
Okay. I'll just stop it there.
I mean.
But he doesn't like nothing. Like, you just see, like.
It's pretty wild.
Yeah. But I mean.
That ain't no sock on his bat.
Nope.
Yeah. I mean, you don't know. Does the parents know
my
this
name's
kid?
Steve Covino, and that this ain't no sucking my crutch.
People aren't getting context also, right? I mean, like, maybe this guy is the worst guy ever. My thought is, it's not nighttime when some criminal's trying to break into your house. This is your daughter's boyfriend, and they broke up. Yeah, if the story, like, we don't know the backstory, but I'm sure the family probably knows this dude. He's probably ate dinner with them. So to shoot and kill him is not shooting.
He was warned. He deserved it. I mean, people are going to have their own opinions.
That's just, you know, that's a faceless troll saying he deserved
it. But I don't know the details. It's wild. I don't know what I'm capable of, but that's why I said the safest option seems to be to have some sort of bat, because I don't want to, like, kill my daughter's future boyfriend. You know, I'd rather have a tussle with him. Be like, hey, hit 27 Little League home runs, bitch.
I mean, to me, yeah, I guess everyone just, you know, you talked about it before. People, the value of life, like, yeah, just fucking kill him.
Yeah, I couldn't live with myself.
Just kill him? I feel bad. Like, again, you don't know. For all we know, you're right. Maybe this guy's like, has a warrant out and he's a jailbird and he's a fucking piece of shit. But we don't, what if 3 days before that he was eating dinner in that family's house and the dad's like, I got a gun. Back up. Like,
what's doing?
We just had fucking Big Ziti 2 nights ago on your kitchen table and now you killed the guy?
Hey, man. I would never put it this way. On the flip side,
you hope you never
I would
deal
never
with
have gone to any ex-girlfriend and
tried to break
disrespected
in.
Her dad's home that way. I could tell
especially
you that.
Especially when he says, I have a gun. You might have backed off then, but still.
I would have never done that shit.
You think he's going to kill you?
When their dads came out and they were like, what's doing? What do you want? I'm like, respectfully, just to say hi. All right, bye, later.
Maybe a little too quick to shoot him. Maybe like, I don't know.
Yeah. It's a story. It's a story.
Too much, it's like, hit him with a gun. It's like, it's too much. There's too much red tape involved with killing someone.
So I'm in bed.
You still have to go to trial. Still have to like go through all the hoopla.
I hear another thud.
It's just not worth it.
Oh, the thud.
I hear another thud
in the bathroom.
Oh man.
Oh no.
Like something dropped. Like something hit. This is in my bathroom. Now I'm like, all right, I'm not hearing shit.
The beat.
Jordan.
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 Jordan. Jordan. Go investigate.
Did you hear that?
Jordan, get my little knife.
Then now she's up. I said, I think I heard something.
Did she say?
I think we got a mouse.
Did she say it in her new? In her new Southern accent. What's going on?
So long story. Let me just finish the story.
What do you think it is, pumpkin?
It's a quick story.
You think it? Well, I fail.
So let me just finish
little
the story.
Little Theo, are you okay?
Let me just finish the story. So now she's there. She's like, I don't hear anything. And then she hears a. I'm like, oh my God, got a fucking mouse. She goes, you gotta get it. I'm like, me? You go get it.
Did you see it?
So I'm like, fuck. She's like, you gotta go. I'm like, I gotta go. Fuck. I don't have a bat. I have no weapons. I don't know what to do. Am I gonna get a broomstick? Ah! Ooh! I don't know. I don't have the a net. I don't have the equipment for this. What am I gonna do?
A net?
What do you do?
A net? Shoe? What is this? What is it? A crab? On the shit, the fucking docks?
Not a fucking
a net.
Dog catcher? I don't know. Like a mouse
net,
catcher?
Like a net launcher?
Think I have a
he thinks he's like a dog catcher in an old cartoon.
You know, we have a bone arrow? What do I need?
What are those things that like you throw and they like wrap around someone's legs?
I did the slowest. I did the slowest one. I'm like, all right, fine, because I got to be the man in this situation, I guess.
Got your flashlight on?
I put my phone flashlight on. And I'm doing this like cartoon sort of tippy toe into the bathroom. And I'm looking around. I see the bathroom. I'm looking around. I'm like, I don't see anything. I definitely heard something. Oh, my God. I'm like fucking. And then I look to the left. And I see the fucking dog on the doing his little doggy dance. Oh. It was the dog. Oh. It was the dog the whole time. How the fuck did it get out? And guess what? Not only that, I'm like, I taste shit.
No.
Oh. Dog fucking got out. I don't know how it got out. It's in a crate.
Oh, okay, I was going to say where it is.
Don't know how it got out of the crate. Don't know how Jordan didn't hear it. Mm-hmm. Got into the bathroom, started rummaging through like bathroom stuff, knocking shit over, and then took a shit on the scale. A shit.
How much did it weigh?
On the scale, and it weighed 2 pounds. Unbelievable. But like what was crazy to me is like I was still up. Jordan's right there facing it. No one heard this dog get out of the crate and tippy toe into the bathroom, but it was I turned the flashlight on, like I caught him. He's like, he does this thing. It was knocking shit over the whole time, but it was the dog. There is no mouse. The end.
That's thank God you didn't like do something. Thank you.
Luckily,
mouse.
I didn't have the bat. I killed him.
Did you ever at any point think to turn the light on?
No, because I wanted to catch this mouse. You know, anyway,
hey, Steve.
Yeah, it does this like it does this stands up. Jordan's trying to teach it to dance. All right, now dance. Good boy.
He's like, oh, good boy.
And he was doing the dance.
Aren't you precious?
After he shit on the scale. So I guess it was better than the mouse, but after that point, I'm like, it's your dog. She's like, oh my God. He's like Houdini. You're like Houdini, aren't you? How'd you get out? So that's my story. There was no mouse.
Good thing you didn't shoot it.
Just a dog that shit on the scale. Thank goodness I didn't have a gun. I would have shot that dog instead of the mouse. Yeah. It's wild. So that's my story. No mouse.
No mouse.
No mouse. Okay. But it does make you think, what if you did have a mouse? What if it was my daughter's boyfriend?
Maybe he saw what you do and how you weigh yourself, take a shit, and then weigh yourself again.
Yeah, dude, maybe, on the scale.
Maybe he wanted to do
that. Yeah,
he
saw you do it, maybe.
Yeah, I do that all the time. You ever do that? Like, you have to take a really massive shit, you weigh yourself. And then you go, you shit, and you go weigh yourself.
No, but
again,
if you ever weigh yourself,
the dog just got it all.
If you ever weigh yourself,
only a half a pound. It felt massive.
If you ever weigh yourself in the morning. You're always the lightest in the morning.
Yeah.
In the morning, you're like, wow, I feel pretty trim. Then by the end of the day, it's like 4 pounds later.
The real crazy part of the story is, and you know, it dragged on, and we talked about this guy who was shot. A lot of you probably forgot that I took the crate. Where's he taking your bed? And I put the crate on the side of the bed. Somehow the dog got out of the crate and snuck into the bathroom. It never dawned on me that it was the dog. I would have imagined that myself or Jordan would have heard the dog get out and walk itself to the bathroom. So that's the part of the story that was still the mystery. But it was the dog the whole time. Pulled some sort of magic trick.
It was the dog the whole time.
It was the dog. Yeah, it's kind of like a Sixth Sense twist at the end.
Whoa.
The dog the whole time.
Whoa.
No mouse. I got another story for you.
Yeah, let's hear all about it, buddy.
Hear about that tennis girl who's getting her ass slapped?
No, I heard about a tennis girl that her dad grabbed her butt. Is that the one?
It's the one.
Oh, yeah. I just saw a still picture. I didn't know it was a video. And I was like,
oh, yeah.
I was like, oh, the dad hugged his daughter. And then I'm like, there was a still picture. It was like, did he like grab his daughter's ass?
16-year-old Sarah Bezlek defeated Heather Watson. Coach Jacob Calhoun and father went buck wild on her ass cheeks afterward in excitement. Now, anybody thinking that it's not a bad look? I don't know.
I got to see the video because I only saw a still picture, and a still picture could be deceptive. So let me see the video.
While speaking to reporters on Tuesday after losing in the first round of the U.S. Open, Bezlek said, of course I saw the video that appeared to show her father, Jaroslav Bezlek, and her coach, Jacob Calhoun, patting her backside repeatedly after qualifying match win on Friday. Now, her description of it, in a nutshell, is this.
I'm in a nutshell.
It was in the moment. Culturally, they're different. They understand it's unacceptable to most people watching, so it'll never happen again. But it was an in-the-moment sort of thing, and everyone was very excited for her.
Yeah. Blow up the screen spot so we could get a full view of this. And we'll just see if we think it's creepers or not.
Creepers or not. She's 16. Remember that.
16?
She just won a big match. Shaking hands.
Okay.
Now she goes to see, you know, her coach. And he's like, give me a handful of that ass. Pat, not yet. Ooh, wait. Oh.
I'll tell you what.
How many pats in the ass is that? That's a lot of pats.
Man, not as bad as I thought.
Hold on. Oh, wait.
Still culturally unacceptable here, but I don't look at that as sexual. I look at that as like, they're treating like a little kid, the way you would like pat your kid on the butt or something. Like,
there's something to be said about that. It's like the perversion is in the eye of the beholder. True. Meaning, like, it goes with that question I posed to you. Like,
I didn't think it was weird when Tom Brady kissed his son and everyone else did.
Meaning, these are the parents and the coach, right? Like, maybe it's so innocent they're not even on that mindset, mind track at all. So therefore, it's like, are you crazy? That's my daughter. How fucking dare you even insinuate that? But culturally, from our perspective, we're like, yeah, that's a little weird.
Yeah, I think it's culturally weird for us, but perhaps you're right. It's like, to me, it wasn't like a sexual grab. It was like almost like, hey, way to go. Like the way a baseball player would pat another baseball player in the butt, but maybe a little too long.
Let's count how many Pats spot. Let's do it again.
Right. Yeah.
How many Pats? I mean, it's a lot. There's two. The two on the upper back don't count. Okay. Because at first, when I first saw this video, I'm like, that's what the hoopla is about. And then you're like, oh, wait, no. The first two don't count.
That doesn't count. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
One more. Come on. Ah, 14.
14. And then
the other guy. One, two, three.
Five.
It's 19 slaps in the ass. 19 slaps.
Yeah, but you see, her reaction was smiling and walking away. Like, culturally, it's like, you know, when you have like foreign people that you meet and you're not, and there's a lot of kisses and you could bump into some foreign relative.
Many slaps in the ass. You could Rich Davison. You're only 2000.
You could bump into a foreign relative, and some grown man could like go to kiss you on the lips, like, "Hey, it's a cousin Annunzio." And you're like, "Yo, I just felt man beard on my face and lips."
I am very understanding of your cultures.
Yeah, I mean,
and I promise it won't happen again.
Culturally,
so that's their take on it, but it's becoming a big story. Like, it's in every major news publication.
I don't know.
And it does pose the question, like, is this a little overboard or not?
I find it to be completely innocent based on the fact that it's his daughter and he probably trained her every moment up until
this. Always hear stories about creepy coaches, too. I mean, you can't be so naive, too, all the time.
It's her dad. It's her dad and the coach. And it's, I don't know,
man. It's not as cut and dry as you're making it.
I think people are sexualizing something that, in this case, isn't sexual, and it's on us as being like, well, why are we so sure to think it's sexual? Like, we're putting ourselves in that creepy mindset. He's probably thinking, this is my kid, and you know.
Yeah, but there's a point in time.
I don't know. You're right.
But again, in our culture, where you start, you know, doing things like
that to
your daughter.
I agree with our feedback.
If I did that to my daughter now, it'd be odd. She's 12.
Yeah, but you're also American.
And I'm also American.
Yeah. Mark said, and I agree with this, I don't get a sexual vibe from that at all, but it's not a good look. And I think we could agree with that. I don't think it's
agreed
creepy sexual, but it's fucking odd as fuck. But it's odd as fuck for an American.
We've heard lots about creepy coaches.
So what do I know? You know, you go, I wonder, you know, I never asked my dad when my dad went to Belarus to visit his wife's family. I wonder if there's some cultural stuff like, male family members kiss me. Like, I don't know. Like, you don't know culturally what other people do.
I didn't like when uncle smacked the backside.
There were a lot. There was excessive booty slaps. That's the thing, too. If it was like
19,
two of them.
Bro.
I know. If he went like this.
We
counted. If he hugged her and he went tap, tap, you'd be like, that's sort of like an odd encouraging.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
19 congratulatory slaps in the ass. Ooh, I don't know.
I agree. It's sad that in this day and age, we only look for the creepiness.
Well,
we can't look at that and be like, yeah.
You have to. There's too many stories of creepy people. It's always the people you didn't expect. It's not always he was a great coach.
But you know what it is, though? I don't give two diddly-doos or shit about this story.
All right, what if she was American? If she was American, it'd be different.
Haven't you given enough of a shit today?
Agreed. I don't give a diddly funk or a pumpkin spice latte shit about this story. However, I agree with what Jason just hit us up with. I was thinking the same. It's not a good look by the American standards we are used to. Culturally, wherever she's from, you tell me, Lithuania, Russia, somewhere in the Eastern Europe, Western Europe. Where is she from, Spot? I mean, isn't that... We're talking about culture. Shouldn't we figure out where she's from?
Czech.
She's from the Czech... She's from the Czech Republic.
Czech. Find it if you can, Spot.
Yeah, Spot, Czech.
I can't find it.
Czech?
Yeah, Czech.
No, Czech.
Yeah, Czech, please. Thank you.
No,
what store did you shop at in the 2000s?
Guess.
Banana Czech? Republic?
Guess.
Old Navy.
Guess.
Yeah. Czech.
Czech.
Maybe... In that part of the world, they're like, yeah, it's no big deal. No big deal at all. It's father, daughter. It's an encouraging slap on the rear end.
We massage butt cheek to show praise and love.
Maybe you don't know that. So again, I agree. We're Americans. So according to us, creepo, move on. I mean.
And that's how they sort of, I don't want to say angled this. That's how they.
Just bring it back. Let's bring back some.
Explained
butt
what was going on. And they're like, in respect to.
Yeah.
The backlash.
Yeah.
We'll make sure it doesn't happen again. Probably the best way to handle it.
If you didn't think it was weird.
16-year-old women different than a baseball player.
If they didn't think it was weird, Would they have done it on a huge stage like the U.S. Open with no regard? They did it like it was normal behavior in their culture and their world. So, hey, what are you going to do?
It's not as cut and dry as you're saying, and I'll tell you what. It wouldn't be as big of a story if it was as cut and dry. That
well,
that.
I mean, you're making it seem like stories don't get blown out of proportion.
It's a bigger story.
Is it a bigger story than Serena Williams wearing diamond-encrusted Nikes?
I mean, look, Stoney Homie's pretty level-headed dude from what I get. He goes, it was overboard, period. You know what I mean? Like, there's two ways to look at this. I do see what you're saying.
It's a non-story.
Sometimes, like, people will question your affection to your kid. And you're like, you crazy? It's my kid. I get that.
Yeah.
I totally get that.
I wonder, does the time ever come where giving your kid a kiss on the lips is weird? Because I don't see when that day comes.
Yeah, that shit would be weird now. Yeah, when you're 11 and Tom Brady's my kid's a preteen. She thinks she wants to kiss dad on the lips?
When you're 11 and Tom Brady's your dad.
I can't imagine, like, all right, give me a kiss, goodbye. A little peck on the lips. I feel like
on a cheek would be, suffice. Hmm.
Do you have a kiss for daddy?
I wonder what age that is. I'll let you know when I feel like I can't kiss my kids on the lips anymore.
You'll know. You know. Yeah. Because they'll be like, yeah, stop. What are you, creep? Lips. By the way, I saw a meme. Speaking of,
I don't know. I wonder when I'll stop doing it.
I mean, hopefully like
10 at a good 9, 8, like 12,
probably once hormones come into play.
Maybe, yeah, when they start growing that way.
Puberty.
It happens gradually. Yeah, you're not gonna have a day and be like, it's over.
Yeah, it's not like it's not for you. It's for the more for them.
I think I feel sad when that day happens.
You think so? But you roll with it. Yeah, you roll with the punches.
Been there.
Like every morning, I'm like, all right, Emmy, love you, buddy.
You think
have fun at school.
My hand anymore? And she's like,
I mean, growth, Dad.
You gradually accept it. Growth. So it's all good.
Golly. Drop me off a block away.
Yeah, I guess you know what the truth is. She'll probably let me know, like, Dad, stop kissing me, gross. And then you feel weird, and you're like, all right, I'll stop kissing you. I don't know.
There's all different mindsets when it comes to stuff like that. You know, hey, love your kids respectfully.
Yeah, I'll kiss my kids until they tell me not to. I mean, I just, you know, you love them so much. I didn't want to give them little kisses. I can't imagine not giving, like, little Ben a little kiss goodnight.
You got to explain to them, too, though. Only mom and dad could kiss you like that. Uncle Bart tries to do that shit, doesn't fly.
We talk about that with secrets.
That can confuse a kid.
No, you can't have secrets. No secrets. Like, secrets is a bad thing.
Secrets.
I saw a meme that was kind of true.
What about secrets?
I
could use one right now.
My dad always had secrets.
I don't think we ever kissed my parents on the lips, but I always thought that was weird. I thought it was under affectionate.
Your dad has really little lips. Yeah.
I thought that was under. My family was under affectionate. Like Sarah's family's super affectionate. I really like that a lot. I feel like your mom's super affectionate to you.
Yeah, but it's like, mom.
I would love that. That's very nice. That's very nice.
You know, when you're smothered that way, it's, you know, honestly, yeah.
I think it's beautiful.
It's a nice thing, but it's like you kind of like, well, why doesn't anyone else like love me this much?
Right?
Yeah.
I like being loved. I like hugs.
Yeah.
Hug me.
Hug me.
Hug me.
Pat me on the ass 19 times. You know what? Yeah. I want 20. One for good luck.
Yeah, that's weird.
You want to show me you love me?
I would love
smack
to be
my ass 20
I would
times.
Love to be patted on the ass.
20 times.
By an old man.
I think about wanting to be patted on the ass by a Czech trainer. Just never happens.
Like I always envied Carrie Strug when Bela Lugosi carried her off.
Tasso and a couple people hit us up saying
I always envy that.
Pre-puberty is about the time where a girl's like, yeah, we're not kissing anymore. So I guess I got a few more years.
I want an old man to carry me off of
I've always wanted to be carried like Bela Lugosi. Is that
right? Bela, I'm thinking of
Bela
the actor.
Lugosi. No. Oh, wait. Who's the traitor? Come on. No.
Bela Lugosi is fucking...
Yeah, he's an actor.
Yeah, that's the Phantom of the Opera.
I know.
Isn't it? No, that's Lon Chaney.
No, who's the dude Lugosi? That carried off like Carrie Strug? Fucking old
Bela
creep
Lugosi
dude.
Is an actor.
Bela Lugosi.
Bela Lugosi. I was like, who's Bela?
Thank you.
Lugosi. I knew it was something close.
Well,
No, Bela Caroli. Yeah,
Bela Caroli.
Bela Caroli.
Bela Caroli.
Who's Bela Carosi, though?
Carry me off. Bela Lugosi wasn't he Dracula?
Dracula. Is that right?
This is all I want.
I believe you're right.
I just want to be carried off.
I knew I was on the right train track.
Spot just wants to be carried.
This is all I want. I just want to be carried.
Just carry me away, like Bella Caroli.
Most of those. Here's the thing. Remember where this comes from. A lot of those trainers were up to no good.
So that's why people their first instinct is creepo behavior. I think that's what it is.
Don't you remember when we were at the ESPYs? How miserable it was because it was all about those gymnasts that were fucking abused.
Of course.
Okay. So that's where it comes from.
That's all Spot wants.
We've heard too many stories. I think Uncle Joe is listening live. Hi, Uncle Joe.
Yeah, because we're free today.
I know. Yeah, he's like, I know. He's like, wait, when is this on? I'm like, I think you're watching live right now.
That's all I want in my life.
Look at Spot. That's all he wants. Be smacked in the ass 19 times.
Spot, what happened to your foot?
I sprained it.
How crazy looking back. I agree with the feedback. That girl broke her foot, right? And they're like, yeah, you're still going to compete.
She wanted to.
I know. It's wild,
because
though, right?
She didn't want to let Bella Caroli down.
Bella, I do not want to let you down.
That's all I want in my life.
Let me hold you.
To be carried
fucking
off.
Creeps. All right. There's stuff to get to still. You talked about your night. You watched the Woodstock 99 documentary.
We went from corn to corn. There is no mouse, just a dog. That's sort of the bane of my existence right now, but he's so cute. So I do like him, I think.
Our dude, Addy, asked me a question that I thought was interesting.
Let's hear it.
Our barber of Seville.
Did he change his phone number? Because I texted him.
No. He was asking, like, would you ever date someone in the military? And I'm like, I'll be honest.
It's an odd question.
My sister Donna would say yes.
Based on what he's doing, I was like, yeah, bro. I mean.
Oh, is he seeing someone new?
Well, no, I think he was.
Colonel Johnson.
It's Commander. Major buddy.
Major buddy.
Commandant Lassard. He was asking, like, if you date someone in the military, like, are you cool with the idea of, like, yeah, I'm willingly dating someone that's going to be gone for a while, for months at a time, don't see him, communication is minimal. And then I said, I would question whether or not you can handle that long distance, being that you're a young dude and there's plenty of booty out there and you're a cool young dude. But I said, if you do care about her, you know, you're going to go for it. However.
Major Woody.
However.
Major Johnson.
Major Chubb. I said the bigger issue to me would be once she's out of this military stuff, who's to say, like, she's going to be able to come back to L.A.? She might be stationed somewhere, and you got your own barber shop and business running out here in Los Angeles. So if you told me in a couple of years after, you know, she may have to fucking do a tour somewhere and come back, and then you'll be nervous for her well-being. You know, to be in the military, you got to be cut from a different courageous type of cloth. I don't know. I said, listen.
By the way, is it a she?
Yeah, it's a she. Okay. I don't know. Yeah.
Does she have a buzz cut?
Does she have a buzz cut? Does she look like G.I. Jane?
And I just said, my thought was.
Is it Tanya who listens to the show? She was in the military.
My thought was.
It's Jason Brown.
Admirable. If you could deal with the long distance, have at it. But the problem is, buddy, you just set up barbershop shop in here in Los Angeles. And I tell you what, no military people are based in Los Angeles. San Diego is probably the closest main area
What branch is she in?
I don't know. She's just, I didn't get the details, but all I know is that.
One of the first questions I asked.
I know. I just said, are you okay with not seeing? What if you guys did this thing where it's like, yeah, whatever. Don't ask, don't tell. Like, I could hook up while you're gone, and while you're in the military, you do what you do. And
don't ask, don't tell is totally different.
Yeah, that was the 90s.
Yeah, nothing to do with this.
But like some type of policy of like, yeah, you know, just don't embarrass each other. Like, and he's like, yeah, she sort of insinuated that. I'm like, well, if you could date and hook up with people and see what's cracking in your life, and she could, I don't know, and then you see her when she's home. I don't know. My thought was, you, a friend, have a new business.
You have to be really confident that you're fucking laying it down and you're the guy.
Yeah, but not only that, I said, what's the end game? Every relationship that has a chance at working needs an end game.
We're in the end game now.
Hey, in 2 years I graduate college and we can move to the same place. in a year from now, I could get a job transfer and we could be in the same place. You know what? I'm able to work from home so we could be here. There's no end game if you're a girl or guy's in the military and they don't know. They could be stationed in Oklahoma.
Addie
or
could give her sweet fades, though.
That's true.
That's a benefit. That's,
I'm and, glad you were there for that input. To, you should have been there.
Like, what's her position? What's her tours of duty? Is she only in it for a certain amount of time, and then is she going to dip out, or does she want to make it a career out of it?
That's my point.
There's many different avenues. All these questions I would have asked. I'm going to ask him. I'm going to see him next week. I'm going to get some follow-up.
Yeah. I mean, when you ask him about his spot, because the reality is, I said, hey, if you really care about her, do it. But, I mean, I can't see how it would last, bud. I got to tell you, because...
And I assume...
They're dating. They're, like, casually dating, but...
Casual.
Again, if... Spot...
I mean, if they're casually dating...
All right, what's
dating,
the end game? Give me the end game. She gets stationed not in Los Angeles. So, is he going to one day be like, yeah, I'm going to stop being a barber and come with you to Oklahoma?
Oklahoma's
like,
nice.
Do you care about her that much? Like, hey, you know, I'm going to be stationed in South Texas.
Hey, man.
Hey.
People have done crazier things for love.
Yeah, man. Yeah, how much does he care about her? Is she, like, very special? Did he get hit with a thunderbolt?
Is she the
didn't,
one?
Didn't seem like it. Just seemed like he was, like, stuck in a scenario. And I'm like, yeah, you know what? Come on.
Then that's a big factor.
That's a big, yeah. If he's not, like, head over heels, if they just started dating and she's going to move away.
I don't think he's, like, in love.
Man, sometimes he seems a little, it's like a quiet guy. I feel like he would appreciate a strong woman.
Yeah.
So I bet
she'll
you, like,
definitely like carry him over. Yeah. The, what's it called?
When
they're married.
Over the threshold. Yeah, he's a little guy. Not a big fella.
Yeah. That's her carrying him.
Her
carrying him. Eddie.
Going over the threshold. Want to take a phone call?
Yeah, sure.
The number's still the same. 412-267-7469. 412, the letter CNR show.
This is Blind Brian.
Brian?
Hey, what's up, guys? Oh,
blast from the past.
Oh, my God.
Way Blind back Brian. On a Wednesday. Where you been, buddy?
It's me, Blind Brian. Yes, I had to call in and say, hey, what's up, you know?
Well, hey, what's up? How you been? How's life?
What's up? Hey, Tom.
Life is treating me well. I'm actually chilling out and hanging out right now. I actually got a new apartment a couple of years, like last year and stuff, guys.
Wow.
Yeah.
Are you smacking any ass in there?
Unfortunately, I had a breakup with my girlfriend over the pandemic and stuff like that because of the distance and stuff like that. But hey, life is life.
Yeah,
how are you all doing?
How's
doing
single great. Life?
Blind Brian, let me ask you. You're blind and all.
What do you think it's tier two?
If you replaced your girlfriend with a body that's as similar to her as possible, do you think you could tell it wasn't her if you were having sex with her?
Probably not. You know what I mean?
Yeah, probably not.
All feels the same.
Can't you read her nipples?
Yeah. Yeah,
she has like braille.
She has braille nipples.
Yeah, I can. How's it going, Spot? Good.
Doing well, thanks. I'm a little under
the
weather.
I'm doing
today.
Well too, guys.
Under the weather.
So, I gotta tell you, it's nice to hear from you, buddy.
I apologize for not having Patreon, but I figured out how to log in on the free thing today on YouTube here, and so what I will do from now on is give you guys a buzz from time to time. You guys on at noon all the time or live?
Yeah. We'll see you then.
Cool.
Stay in touch.
Hey, stay cool. Be awesome.
Hey,
thanks.
You stay
Bye.
Cool.
Nice to hear from Blind Brian.
Blind Brian.
Blind Brian. I want to know how many times he spanked her in the ass. 19 is the magic number. By the way, put that in perspective. Your beautiful wife and girlfriend, okay? Whether if she's in the military or, you know, she bakes cookies or both. 19 slaps in the ass in a row is excessive.
Well, some of them are like golf slaps.
Yeah, if I were to hug,
do that
a woman,
in your real, do that
like,
in your real
tap,
life.
Tap, tap.
After the ninth slap, I think she'd be like, "Stop it, try it." And I think that answers the question. I was thinking about that
excessive slappage.
19 slaps in the ass. After two, Jordan's like, "Okay,
that's enough. I'm not a toy."
Yeah. So think about that again. military slaps
do
in the
have
ass.
Slap at me, peaches.
Yeah, military slaps. I don't know.
I don't know.
Military slaps?
I'm just saying, I don't know if I could date a military woman because she's probably more manly than I am.
I mean, easy.
I mean, then again, most people are, so it's okay.
True.
True, true, true.
It's my own Ben's insecurities. Yeah. I think if it's the real answer, if the person's worth it, you'll do things you probably said you'd never do.
You know, I'm thinking about it. Matt hit us up with a good point. Have you, what is the most you've ever slapped a girl in the butt? Yeah, I'm talking, even in a sexual moment, like
I played
four in a row. Like,
Do bongos count?
You could have a butt in front of you in a sexual situation and give it a couple slaps, but you would never give it 19 slaps.
I always end it with a karate chop, just to, you know, be mad.
Down the middle, though?
Yeah, it's right in the middle. Just to
split them.
Just to be memorable.
Well,
so when that next guy comes along.
Meanwhile.
She's like, oh, but he didn't karate chop me.
Meanwhile, here's my house on a Tuesday night.
See?
This is the only time you should slap 19 times in a row.
When you're like.
Oh, did you see that?
When you're doing babaloo on some butt cheeks.
Was that a paradiddle?
If you're doing butt bongos like this guy.
That was a double paradiddle.
19? Only time.
This guy. Have a butt cymbal. Butt drums, great. Butt cymbal.
Why didn't they offer this in high school? I would have played percussion.
If I knew this was available, I wouldn't have played the alto saxophone.
What are you doing? Practicing for the concert.
What do you think denotes the...
Honey, I'm taking a music class. Why are you gone every Thursday night? It's a music class. That's all I can say.
So does the bigger and looser the bigger and looser the cheek creates the lower tone? Is that how it works?
Yeah, it's like when you fill glasses of water at different levels and it makes different notes. The bigger the Covino, what did you say? Maybe the bigger the crack, the lower the note? Because that has more reverberation?
So I think about that.
All right, we good?
These are great,
I gotta tell you,
these are great sounds.
I'm actually very impressed with his skills.
I mean, he's a percussionist.
I want to see Desi Arnaz do this shit.
Bongos are not easy to play, especially butt bongos. Oh, look at that.
You think Ricky Ricardo did this show with Lucy?
Do you think butt number three in this progression spot enjoys being what seems to be the snare? She gets the most butt slapping.
Yeah,
right there, yeah. This guy's like Tito Puente.
Right, all right.
I should have my belly at the end for the bass drum.
By the way, everyone's coming out of the woodworks today. Black Adam, what's up?
Yo, Black Adam.
What up, Doc?
What up, Doc?
Hey, what's up, Doc? Hey, let me start over. What's going on, gentlemen?
What's up, buddy?
Hey, how y'all doing today, man?
Yo, Black Adam, you ever play the butt bongos?
Who?
You ever play the butt bongos? You ever slap a bunch of asses all at the same time?
Yeah, my 20s when I was at college.
Oh. Yo, I got a serious question for you. How many times consecutively do you think you ever slapped an ass?
How many times in a row?
Yeah.
Like have you ever hit? You ever think 19 is? You ever think you've surpassed 19?
Wapa.
19's a lot.
Oh shit! I'm at least 24.
Okay, so yeah.
All right, maybe it's not so weird. Yeah. Okay, so go ahead. What's up, buddy?
What up, Doc? Hey, man. And then I want to say, Rich, I like your other show. Something about why the fuck we had children.
Oh, that's the name of the show. Why the fuck we have children?
Yeah.
With Nicole. Yes, Nicole. Why the fuck we have children?
Man, I caught that the other day, man. I like that, man.
Thank you, man. We have new episodes every Thursday, so you can check out a new one tomorrow. Okay. I'm actually recording it in about an hour.
The only reason I called, man, I just got an inbox from, I can't think of the name. Bob Elliott talking about calling, man. You know, I'm at work, and I really can't listen to the show until I'm off work. So I hear y'all every day, but I can't call in because I don't want to get fired.
Well, don't get fired, but it's great to hear your voice.
We appreciate you, man.
Don't worry about it. And I'm going to say mozzarella.
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 Thank you, Black Adam.
Mozzarella. Hey, have a great day, brother.
Love hearing from you, man. Thank you, Black Adam. What's up, Doc? Can we rock? Thank you, bro.
I'm going to suggest, today when I talked in the call, I'm going to suggest we rename the show.
Why the fuck
we have children?
Attention on deck.
Why the fuck we got children?
All right. Well, thank you all for hanging out with us. As far as rando news, the story I really wanted to discuss most was the ass slapping, to be honest.
Yeah, that's...
That's one friends keep sending me because it's a debate. It's like, is it excessive? When you put it in perspective, 19, it's like, you ever see a long hug? Remember there was like stories about they were hugging really long? Who did that? And then we did that experiment.
And it was like, oh, that's a long time. Like,
yeah, that's a long time.
Or oh, wasn't it a baseball a game where they were all hugging for a long time? Like 24 seconds. Remember there was that we reenacted it?
Longest hug.
When you think about smacking someone in the ass 19 times, that's excessive.
So I feel like number three, right? So three from the left is really getting it.
Yeah.
Maybe she deserves it.
And like number four is right butt cheek. It's really getting some, but like number three, look, number three.
You think your wife would get mad at this spot?
What people don't know is number three is Rich Davis.
It's me. People don't realize.
He picks his head up at the end. At the end of the video, he picks his head up.
What do you think?
Surprise!
Spot, if you told Kristen you were at a party and there were butt bongos and you played.
Be okay with it.
This dude's getting he's getting down.
My brother's really good at he missed out. My brother should have done this, James. He's a percussionist.
It's amazing.
Wow.
He really is great.
Well done.
Wow. Hey. I'd go see that.
I have a story.
Is he performing at the Hollywood Bowl?
I have a story if you want to.
Why isn't that on America's Got Talent?
If you want to get into another rando news story. Southwest Airlines.
That's on Brazil's Got Talent.
That would get my golden ticket.
Southwest Airlines.
Wait, hold on, it's news.
Yeah.
Butt bongos.
Snooze.
American Southwest Airlines. There was a flight where the pilot got on his little microphone and told the passengers, please stop airdropping photos. There was someone on the plane that was just airdropping that. All the passengers.
That's so great.
Junk shots.
Junk
That's
shots.
So fantastic.
Inappropriate.
I feel like we were at, what was it?
Could have been a kid.
We were at
I don't find it
Yard House in Los Angeles.
That's funny.
For something one time. I think a group of our friends all got together.
It was a bowling alley.
It was at Yard House, too. I feel like I was with you at Yard House.
Well, you know what? We went
with maybe
to
like
places that night. So
that's what it was.
Yep.
We were at we went to a bowling alley in Yard House for someone's birthday. And I remember out of nowhere, like we all looked at our phones and someone in Yard House had airdropped a big, huge black penis to everyone in the whole bar.
Oh, that was me.
And we were like, yo, is it one of us? Come on. Who is it?
By the way, it was just tan from vacation.
Oh, well, take a look at this.
He's doing that. So here's the deal. This continues while we're on the ground. I'm going to have to pull back to the gate. Everybody's going to have to get off. We're going to have to get security involved. Oh. And it's vacation that's going to be ruined. So you folks, whatever that airdrop thing is, let's send a naked picture. Let's get yourself to Cabo.
Let's get ourselves to
naked
pictures.
To Cabo. You know, people on their way to Cabo.
All these people are horned up. All these people are horned up going to Cabo, and someone's like, I'm going to send dick pictures to everyone on this plane.
Did the pilot really just basically say, if you don't stop it, I'm going to turn this car around?
Yeah, he pretty much. He was like, yeah, you behave, or we're not going to Cabo.
I'm turning this plane around.
Naked. Shit. Naked. Dude,
I always keep a photo on standby to send on airdrop. It's like the weirdest photo.
You've been junked.
It's not a junk photo.
That is a funny thing. Can you get caught? Can they ever identify who's the sender?
No. Doesn't it say like if you so and so would like to send you?
Like right now. No, because right now, hold on. Let's see if it works. I'm going to take a random picture on my phone. Send me something. And I'm going to go to airdrop it. And if I go to airdrop it, you and Sarah are both available. Oh, and Covino, three people.
Dickie Davis would like to share a photo.
Wait, is this...
Oh, but see, you're in my contacts.
Is this a
contacts.
Naked picture of Ben?
But what if you're not in my contacts? Would you get it?
No, it's Rich's head.
It's just, it says Rich Davis would like to share a photo.
No, so I guess
so it's contacts.
If they're not in your contacts, yeah. Okay.
I don't know if they're not.
Well, it's sort of like Rickrolling someone, but with a dick pic.
Any other rando news? Oh. By the way, I find it to be funny in the right company. The story Rich told, I thought that was the right company. You're at an adult establishment at a plane. It could be kids there.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, inappropriate. You really got to keep those things in mind.
How about this?
So you're really junking somebody at that point.
Name the celebrity that came out yesterday and said, I am obsessed with sex again. It's my new hobby.
What? Britney Spears.
Older. A celebrity
Martha Stewart.
Who says they are obsessed with sex.
Give me a hint.
Person also went on to say she regrets her marriages and says sex is her, quote, new obsession again. She wants to have it all the time. Someone known for
sex. We're trying to figure it out. Someone, is it Madonna?
Yeah. Ew, 64 years old. Madonna has come out and said, she did a Q&A on YouTube and she said, while she's constantly surrounded by her family, she admits that her guilty pleasure is that she is again obsessed with sex. It's her current obsession. She
was all horned up. She had sex with Weird Al back in the day. Remember that? Yeah. Weird Al was like, I just want to do a parody. She's like, yeah, not unless you bang me. It's in the new movie.
Madonna saying that she loves sex the way she did back in the day.
Like a virgin.
Ugh.
She's like, hey,
Madonna. So I thought that was interesting. 64. Nice to know that she still has the appetite.
For destruction.
Men, I imagine men and women go through different stages in their life where they're very sexually charged and then they're sort of like asexual, then they're sexually charged, and then they're asexual. I feel like that's just a progression of of life.
Why do you think that like retirement homes are just rampant with STDs?
I'm always wonder how accurate that is versus just that's funny stories.
So accurate.
Oh yeah, I believe
that. A bunch of 80-year-olds just banging?
Yeah.
80.
Hey, my parents, my kids left me here. Kids left me here too.
Bored,
Kristen interacts with a lot of old veterans and they're all just like
bored and horny.
Rampant with STDs.
Yeah, that's weird.
Yeah, but Spot, if your family left you, if let's say you were 80-something and you were a widow.
Come here.
And you're like an 8-year-old
guy. Like an old bag.
What do you do? You're like, today we're gonna play bingo. I'm going to play go for a walk. And then we're going to go fuck your Ethel.
You're a widower. That's like when you're a man.
You're a widower. You doing that? You 80-year-old guy that's going to be banging at a nursing home?
Yeah, come here, Ethel.
Would you even want 80-year-old ass?
Come here, Jen. Let me grab that ash.
I don't know. Stephanie. Yeah, all the names. Jessica. Those are the old names in 30 years. I just want
come here, Stacy.
There's nursing homes in Florida. There's nursing homes in Florida that apparently have the highest STD per capita. Which
are you ever going to be at the mindset, even when you're 80, where you see another like 80-year-old and you're like, I think I would.
That's an interesting point. I wonder when it stops, and I'll tell you why. Because I used to think I would always choose.
I'll be 80 and I'll think like a young man.
I can't
do that.
Maybe it stops at a certain point. Because remember, I told you that. I used to think that I would never choose anything over like the hot college girl. And now I told you recently, over the last years, I much prefer like the hot 30 to 40 year old, like in shape woman that like looks fucking great. So I wonder maybe does it keep going as you get older or are you permanently locked in? Like, all right, 40 is my limit. After that, I don't
I think you mature.
Yeah, but you really think an 80 year old's like, look at that 80 year old.
I mean, I think it's just what's in front of you.
I think you're in love with her heart at that point.
Yeah, like she's a wonderful woman. Like,
well, you'll see your partner grow up with you, but I'm saying if you're a single 80-year-old guy, I don't think you're like, you can do.
I mean, it goes both ways.
Look at the shaggy titties on her.
Your earlobes are hanging down to your shoulders. She's not like, oh, I bet you Harry will really make my toes curl.
Like, obviously, if you're in a home, right? You only have access. I mean, you're going to like look at the young nurses and be like, yeah, I'd hit that. But they're not going to want to hit it back. You know who wants to hit it back? All the other old people. So you take what you can get.
Think of the nurse while you bang Ethel.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
You think all those old guys?
Let's say there was a nurse there that was like into old dudes, and she was like, she wanted to do it.
You think it's a terribly gross question, but you think a lot of those old dudes just sit around like fucking with no shame, just like whacking it all day, like as a nurse walks in, he's like, hey,
I'm gonna have no shame when I get older.
Probably.
When you get older.
I'm gonna
are you saying he's old now? Or
no, I'm saying like you think like.
Can I request edging from my nurse? Is that considered a medical procedure?
I believe I'm due for my noon edging.
Slower.
Spot buys like the fucking premium platinum package at the nursing home where every day a nurse jerks him off. Well, don't think that's not out of the question 50 years from now.
It's a medical procedure.
Think about where the world will be in 50 years.
Any other rando news? Again, Madonna's an exception. You know, I'm not that surprised. She's all horned up all the time.
Airport, airline, fucking nudie drops, obsessed with sex, Madonna.
The coach.
There's a
slapping ass.
There's one story that we could sort of wrap it up with, and it's the ending of a show, in my opinion. season 10 of The Goldbergs, which is a show I've loved over the years. I haven't watched really much over the last year, but early on, we could all agree when the kids were young, The Goldbergs was like a top network show over the last decade.
I've enjoyed a few episodes, for sure.
You've enjoyed a lot of episodes, not
enjoyed
just a few
seasons. As Adam got older, I got less interested.
Oh no, I agree.
He wasn't cute anymore.
I think that of the 10 seasons, I'd say the first 5 or 6 seasons are pretty fucking off, like awesome.
Some great.
And I think what happens is the kids start going to college, and Erica goes to college, and you know, unfortunately, in real life, Grandpa died. Pops died.
Paps.
And now, because Jeff
Garland
had the fight with ABC in the studio, he's off the show. This season, they're writing in that he dies. And Erica and her boyfriend.
Hold on, but the real Adam Goldberg, did his dad die?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So it kind of goes with the storyline?
A little earlier, they
what
say.
What a coincidence.
But Murray Goldberg is getting killed.
When he was younger?
Relatively younger.
Really? Yeah.
But Murray Goldberg is getting killed off because Garland's off the show.
Mm-hmm.
And Erica and her husband, you know, the nerdy guy, Jeff, that was the friend of Barry Goldberg.
Yeah.
They have a kid. So all the formula for like a show being over, like introduce baby and kill off cast members. So
what does that say about life? That it's kind of over once you hit those points.
Well, they,
once
yeah.
kids are involved and, you know, Paps is gone.
Well, they killed off Murray. Pops died in real life. And they introduced in the new season, they'll introduce a baby because I guess Erica got married last season at the end. So the show just took on a life of its own. I'm sure it's still
does. When there's a little redheaded kid with a pumpkin pie haircut.
But that was my analogy. It's like Married with Children, even on Growing Pains. As much as we love Leonardo DiCaprio, when he joined Growing Pains, or when the redheaded kid joined Different Strokes, or
his name was
Married with Children. Seven, right? Or the little boy. So yeah, Garland got killed off. Bummer. Modern Family, I agree. Modern Family was fantastic, but in the very end, they did start adding like babies and
such is life. You know, when things like that happen, the family dynamic changes.
Yeah, and in real life, it's awesome. Yeah. But on a sitcom, where the whole joke is that like Adam's being smothered by his mother.
That's a good way to say, well, this is where their life went.
Yeah. Goodbye.
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 Goodbye. Goodbye. And then maybe we'll get a reunion 10 years later. That's what Malcolm's trying to make happen.
Malcolm in the middle?
Yeah.
Is he still in the middle?
He said everyone's on board except for the kid with the big giant ears.
Oh, what was his name?
They don't know. I don't know. That kid, his brother. But he said Bryan Cranston's everyone's on board to be like, where's that family now?
Mom, too.
He said everyone. I saw a little interview recently about
best.
It. So we'll get a reunion.
Now there's speculation. Could Garland leave Curb Your Enthusiasm as well? I don't know why he'd want to do that, but they're saying maybe.
I feel like they're a little bit more forgiving over at HBO.
He was a little aggressive with
the staff,
the showrunners and stuff like that.
Yeah, apparently he was just like, very old school with like jokes and.
You got like just calling people sweet tits and stuff like that. Kind of behavior. Along those lines.
I don't know.
I don't think he was slapping asses.
As long as they don't get rid of JB Smoove.
Nah, he's the best.
Yeah.
Well, that's your rando news. Now, coming up, just want to thank you guys again for a kick-ass August. I can't believe it's over already. Remember, September. It's going to be a September to remember. September full of fun. And kick-ass news.
And changes.
So we want you all to be a part of it. So if you're here today for the free show, you know, I hope you subscribe to our September Patreon.
Yeah, uncensored.
We have Behind the Velvet Rope. We have different tiers available.
Some archives
now available. Some CNR moments in history available on our Patreon. And just appreciate your friendship and all your support. Spread the word. And let's make it a great September, guys.
Good. Enjoy the remaining hours of August.
A few shout outs. Michael Weiss. Thank you, Michael Weiss. Thank you, Carmine Trovato. Carmine Trovato. All the Carmines. If your name's Carmine, you deserve a shout out. And everyone that we saw today that we hadn't seen in a minute. Blind Brian, thanks for the call. Black Adam, we appreciate you. Uncle Joe, who's watching today. What's up, Uncle Joe?
One more call.
Yeah, sure. One more call to end the day.
Make Miguel. All of them are coming out.
And Miguel.
Shout out to all the Miguels. What's up, Miguel?
What are they? Tacos Locos.
Hey, what's up, Miguel?
Forever.
Shout out to Jorge and Sylvia Pena for saving you Crossroads.
Orale, I can't wait to watch it.
What's up, buddy?
There you go. You got to get you. What do you got? A DVD player now.
Yeah, now you got to find yourself a DVD player to watch it.
I got a copy Crossroads. Of Crossroads for my birthday.
There you go. Hey, y'all be kicking ass. The show's been having me rolling. I've been on vacation. I've been playing this. Y'all out here working in the sun. Y'all are kicking ass.
Hey, thanks, Miguel, man. After a good day of work, how many times do you slap your coworkers in the ass?
My coworkers? Without there, no, but dude, fuck that shit.
All right, so zero. Yeah, not 19. Not 19.
19 times. You know what? Here's the physical challenge of the day. Miguel, love you, buddy.
Slapping women in the ass is like, man, every once in a great while, even when I was young, man, I don't get off on that. I'd rather just slap that ass with my body.
There you go. Slap that ass. Slap that ass
19 times?
The physical challenge today is how many times could you smack your wife or girlfriend? I'm not trying to get anybody arrested.
Bye, Miguel.
In the ass until she like says, enough. What are you doing? 19 times is a lot. If you can get 19 times, you just won the Sarah Bezlek challenge.
Thanks, Miguel.
I'm gonna try it on Sarah. Thank you, Miguel. As soon as we leave the room now. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to walk into the kitchen,
19 times.
Refill my coffee. I'll get a new coffee.
And
I'm gonna be like,
and one for good luck.
I'll be like, oh, you're going to go pick Ben up from school? Come here. Give Sarah a hug. And I'm going to go boom, boom. I'm going to see if I get to 19 before she says, what are you doing?
Remember, some of them were like really quick. Some of them were like really
good. The coach was it was 14 and 5.
I'm going to let, you know what I'll do? I'll have my phone. I'll be recording on my phone to see what I could get away with. 19, that's the challenge, guys. See if you could slap your wife's ass 19 times.
That's the physical challenge.
Before she says, what are you doing?
And then I want you to go down the Sunday slide and grab the flag.
And pull the flag out of the
nose. That's your physical challenge of the day.
Find the flag in the waffle, in the huge waffle.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. So thank you guys again for all your support, your subscription this August. I hope you enjoyed the free show today. Let's see you in September. Let's make it happen in September.
Yeah.
Remember, you could listen and watch anytime on Patreon.
One more short end.
Sure, who do we got?
Let's see. He called himself Ralph Busio, which throws me off, but it's Rafael Busio.
I love that guy.
Hey, muy sucio.
A shout out for him and his girlfriend, Annabelle.
Thank you,
Rafael Busio. And her daughter, Miracle.
Oh, Miracle. I am your new papa.
Who listens to Rich on Pop 2K.
Oh, look at that.
Nice.
I love the Busio. It's a good man.
Thank you, guys.
Hey, if it's your birthday today, by the way, you share that with Richard Gere, who will forever be affiliated with the gerbil. And I felt bad when I thought about that. I was like, poor guy, for the rest of his life.
It's weird. True. How old is Gere?
73.
And the gerbil up his ass is like 43 at least.
Crazy. All right, we'll see you guys tomorrow, starting a new month. I'll see you in September.
Tell your friends.
Arrivederci, baby.
See you in the promised land.
Have a good one. Bye.